I'm Doug Brown. COVID-19 cases and contact tracing up around the NFL. Three more for Washington today, bringing their total to 21. But ESPN's Adam Schefter reports the league is not likely to postpone any games right now.
Do you think the NFL, which has a Saturday window with no college football on for the first time this season, wants to go give up a game that's been planned for months? I don't think so. And the league doesn't feel it has to.
Adam Schefter on KJ and Max. All three Chicago Bears coordinators are now in COVID-19 protocols. Ravens quarterback Lamar Jackson missed practice again today with his sprained right ankle. Just the second time this season he's missed back-to-back days with an injury. His status for Sunday against the Packers could be a game-time decision. From college basketball, Saturday's Ohio State-Kentucky game in Las Vegas canceled because of COVID-19 issues in the Buckeyes program. Mercedes drops the appeal of its two protests of the Formula One season finale in Abu Dhabi. Mercedes driver Lewis Hamilton lost the race and a chance for his eighth world title.
At Napa, when it comes to serving you, their motor never quits. From next day delivery to curbside pickup, get the parts you need when you need them. That's Napa know-how.
Moscona.
I'm very important.
After further review.
Say one more time.
After further review with Matt Moscona.
And here we go.
ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge Studios.
Let's ride!
And off we go. Welcome aboard. Glad you're with us. AFR presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. I'm Matt.
Love you, Matt.
Paul O'Neill.
They're chanting Paul O'Neill's name.
And Mr. Toby Tomplay. All right, we're here. Glad you are as well. Get out there and make it a good one. Man, do we have a lot to delve into. Jerit Roser will be with us in 15 minutes. Leah Vann, new LSU beat writer from The Advocate. She'll be in studio with us next hour. Mike Triplett talking some Saints in hour three, as he does each Thursday here during the NFL season. Man, do we have a lot to get to. So we spent pretty much the bulk of the show on Wednesday talking about the early signing period. And if you missed the crux of my comments, it was basically quality over quantity to lay the foundation. And LSU most certainly did that. And we also have talked for many, many weeks about how LSU is going to continue losing more players and gaining more players. It's the nature of what happens when you have a coaching change and you have that type of turnover. It's just the nature of it. We learned that Elias Ricks is transferring to Alabama last night, which really was a turd in the punch bowl on an otherwise really positive day. And today, we also learned that Trey Palmer is entering the transfer portal and won't be available for the bowl game, and LSU lost another player. But more importantly, most importantly, LSU gained a couple of players, and one of them is a familiar face. If you missed the news today, Myles Brennan announced he will return to LSU, and FIU All-American offensive lineman Miles Frazier announced that he is committing to LSU. So a huge get at two massive positions of need for LSU. If you go through this timeline here with Myles Brennan, this is just obviously just massively significant. Back on November the 1st, Myles Brennan, with a post on social media, announced that he was entering the transfer portal, foregoing the remainder of his time at LSU, and essentially expressing his love and appreciation for everything LSU, but then obviously was looking for an opportunity to start. So he left. That was November the 1st. And last week, as we saw reports that Myles Brennan was being courted by Southern Miss and Nebraska and some other programs, we saw this very sort of cryptic post on his Instagram story, which is sort of like light whitewashed image, black and white image, like clouded in smoke of Myles Brennan, where you can really just see his helmet, his LSU helmet, and the ball being thrown from his hand. It was a very cryptic post with no text or context anywhere, just that image on his Instagram story. That was a week ago. It was last Thursday when he tweeted that. And then sometime between last Thursday and today, apparently Myles Brennan and Brian Kelly had a conversation, because Myles Brennan today at 11:01 a.m. Central Time tweeted, "There's no place like home. Let's ride Tiger Nation." And he had the video from the Wolf of Wall Street, the I'm Not Leaving video, which is actually really well done. So a nice job there by Myles Brennan to emphatically announce that he's returning to LSU for a fifth season. And the way the story is kind of has unfolded is apparently Brian Kelly realized he was going to have to go into the portal to get a quarterback so he could go find one, or he could get Myles Brennan. Talked to Myles Brennan, said, "I want you back," and Myles Brennan agreed. It seems like it's that simple as of right now. But this is fantastic news that really doesn't need to be explained. There was, I'll say it again right now, there was no chance at all, no chance at all, that LSU was going into the 2022 season with only Garrett Nussmeier and Walker Howard. You cannot intentionally go into a season with two scholarship quarterbacks. You're a turned ankle away from having a walk-on as your backup. You can't do it. And Brian Kelly was going to have to go get a transfer some way. We debated earlier this week, should it be Keaton Slovis? Should it be Zach Calzada? Should they go after, Cameron Ward from Incarnate Word? Like, what actually fits? Who makes sense? I mean, that was the conversation we were having earlier this week. The best option would have been one of the guys you had, either Max Johnson or Myles Brennan, and they ended up settling here on Brennan, a guy that's been in Baton Rouge since 2017, committed before his senior year of high school, committed to Cam Cameron and Les Miles, y'all. When he was still a seldom thought after prospect, they saw him, liked him, offered him. Then he goes to the opening, blows up, becomes a four-star that everybody started offering. Les Miles and Cam Cameron, y'all. That's like a ghost of LSU's past that's still tied here with Brennan. That's how long he's been part of our lives. I mean, I remember sitting at Pluckers doing a remote when then LSU commit Myles Brennan came on the show and told the story of how his family in Bay St. Louis was so disrupted by Hurricane Katrina, and they lived on a boat for a year in Destin and only went back to the Mississippi coast because it was time for him and his brother to play football. And he talked about the injury his brother had at Ole Miss and him coming up through Stanislaus and all of it. I mean, it's been a long time that Brennan's been part of our lives. And this has a little bit of a Hollywood movie script feel to it, that after all of the time waiting, having the opportunity to play in that loss to Troy back in 2017, then really riding the bench the rest of the season, except I think he had mop-up duty in the game against Alabama that year with the Matt Canada year in 2017. And then voluntarily taking the red shirt in 2018 to preserve a year while Burrow came in, waited his turn, sat behind Burrow in 2019 for a championship season. Finally, it was his turn in 2020. He comes out with great statistics the first three games, but ultimately as the injury against Missouri cost him the rest of the season before this season even pushes off from the dock. Well, that's an unintentional pun. He breaks his arm on a fishing trip. I mean, to have entered the portal and then they've seen Max Johnson enter the portal, clearing the path back to LSU, is just the kind of thing that's abnormal. It's atypical and unusual at very least. But here it is. You have a veteran quarterback that knows this place, that knows the culture, that knows the roster, that knows the receivers, that is a team leader, that's been around, that's hoisted a championship trophy, has a rapport with these guys. It makes a lot of sense instead of trying to bring in someone new to be your leader for 1 year before you hand the reins to one of the younger guys. And I'll remind you this as well. It's especially apropos today when we have a story of a guy like Elias Ricks leaving LSU for Bama that has a lot of people upset. When Myles Brennan broke his arm all the way back before fall camp, his dad, Owen Brennan, went on WWL radio and said this about his son.
He was getting ready to compete for this job starting on Friday, and I assure you, whatever other Friday he shows up, he's going to be competing for the job. And he wants to finish his career at LSU as the starting quarterback. Whatever avenue that is, whatever path that takes, that's his goal.
How appropriate. Whatever avenue, whatever path. This is certainly an avenue and a path less traveled, but it's one that has led to that goal of Myles Brennan finishing his career as the starting quarterback at LSU. And he's going to have the opportunity to win that job in spring, which I presume he will, over Nussmeier. And as we've told you before, Walker Howard is very willing to take a red shirt. I don't think his dad wants him playing as a true freshman, understanding the perils of what can come of being a young guy playing in the SEC. It's better to learn and grow and develop and all that sort of stuff. It's a really perfect scenario for Myles Brennan to finish his career and see what he can do as a starter at LSU, the opportunity he waited for so long, and also the opportunity to let the young talent continue to grow and cultivate into this new system under Brian Kelly. It is a really good bridge between these two eras. And great to see Myles Brennan back at LSU here to finish his career the way we all hoped that he'd be able to as a starting quarterback at LSU. All right, it's after further review. Let me knock out a quick break. Jerit Roser is going to join us. I really want to talk to Jerit about some of the lesser-known guys, especially the late additions to this LSU class. Few people cover high school football in Louisiana better than Jerit, so we'll talk about those guys, those diamonds in the rough potentially, with Jerit Roser when we return on AFR.
AFR.
Brought to you by Hancock Whitney Bank, the official banking partner of LSU Athletics and of the New Orleans Saints. HancockWhitney.com, HancockWhitney.com. Getting close to the holiday season, of course. Christmas time is upon us, and Hancock Whitney Bank during this time wants to remind you about their commitment to all of our communities that they've been committed to for 120 years. Right here along the Gulf Coast, if you're in Baton Rouge where we sit today, if you're in New Orleans, any really part of this state or along the Gulf Coast, your dreams, our mission, that's been the mantra at Hancock Whitney Bank for more than a century now. You can learn more if you need help on what accounts to choose, not really sure, go to the website. There's great info right there on recommendations. Or you can walk into any of the financial centers along the Gulf Coast and find a Hancock Whitney Bank near you. HancockWhitney.com, HancockWhitney.com, member FDIC, Hancock Whitney Bank, the official banking partner of LSU Athletics and the New Orleans Saints. If you've recently been in an accident, you're probably saying to yourself,
to take care of you and your automotive needs. Enjoy this holiday season with family and friends. From our family to yours, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year!
Vizzy, the first hard seltzer with antioxidant vitamin C. It just hits different. Vizzy, step up your seltzer game.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
During these challenging times, we know your healthcare needs don't stop. Cancer, accidents, injuries, and heart disease are relentless. So we are relentlessly innovating to keep you safe, both virtually and in person, connecting you with providers remotely, advancing clinical spaces, providing rapid and accurate testing, social distancing, and certified cleaning protocols. We are Ochsner, and we will not slow down. Ochsner Health, innovating healthcare.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Mastery Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Mastery Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
Brian Kelly inks 13 signees on the first day of the early signing period. Myles Brennan is back in the boat now. Miles Frazier, the big offensive lineman from FIU, has committed to the Tigers as a transfer. Jerit Roser is good enough to join us for a couple of minutes here to talk about it as it all has come together. Hey, man, thanks for the time. We appreciate you for making it work with us today after a little bit of a hiccup yesterday, man. How are you?
Yeah, Matt, not too bad. I appreciate you having me, certainly. Yesterday had kind of a little fittingly signing day feel with some of the chaos and seeing how it goes and having to react on the fly, but happy I got a chance to join you all today.
Yeah, thank you so much, man. I said this before you came on. There's few people, I think, in the state that cover high school football in the state more in depth than you and the crew, the Louisiana versus all y'all. I know you're with Tiger Details as well. So I want to ask you about some of the prospects that have joined this class late that maybe LSU fans are trying to familiarize themselves with. Let's start with Landon Ibieta, the wide receiver out of Mandeville. What can you tell us about him as a prospect and how this kind of came together late?
Yeah, I think that's a great place to start. I love Landon as a prospect. Had a chance to spend a lot of time with him over the last couple years, particularly this spring and summer, following around that bootlegger 7-on-7 organization. And he started that season in January for a huge tournament down in Miami where his recruitment had kind of stalled for several months. He'd had a couple early offers from, I think it was Tulane, South Alabama, and Louisiana Tech had kind of paid some attention, but then everything had stalled on him. And he goes down to Miami to a really high-profile tournament and just starts dominating in a way that very few receivers are able to do against some of the top defensive back prospects in the country. It was just going up over and mossing guys that were picking up offers from Clemson and Alabama and Texas in one of the more dominant showings I think I've seen in that sort of a setting. And immediately some Power 5 offers came his way, including Miami. Shortly after that, Mickey Joseph was kind of in his ear and talking about some different things, some routes and trying to get a look during, at that point, still a shutdown pandemic era of recruiting, was trying to get some clips of what he looked like running certain routes and things like that. And he came to LSU in June, had a phenomenal camp in June. I really thought he was going to get the offer that day. But at that point, A.J. Johnson, Aaron Anderson, and Dakotas Crawford were all committed. Shaz Preston still seemed like a more realistic possibility in that class. And so they ran up against kind of a numbers issue. And then you kind of fast forward through a strong senior campaign for him this fall. And a new staff comes into place. Frank Wilson, Brian Pullian, and company get a hold of Landon Ibieta's highlights and take about 45 seconds to realize that the situation is different, both in terms of the numbers and them kind of seeing him a little bit better and realizing they've got to make a move on this kid quickly. And at that point, I don't think there was a lot of question to to me or folks that knew Landon or his family that LSU was going to jump in a pretty prime position to steal him at the end. And I think great opportunity for him, great get for LSU, and look forward to watching him play in Tiger Stadium.
Is there a comp for Arrieta?
I'm not sure. I'm honestly terrible at comparing of that nature. Yeah. I know. I will tell you this. The first thing that people think is they look at him and say, oh, he's a white wide receiver, and start trying to do all those comparisons. I've watched this guy make flat out plays all over the football field, up and down, across the middle, over guys, everywhere. And so don't get kind of hung up on that little stereotype of
the Wes Welker. He's the Wes Welker
exactly.
type.
Exactly. he's more, and no knock on Wes Welker. He's obviously been a phenomenal football player at every level, but don't kind of pigeonhole Landon off of that.
Let's talk about the defensive backs that also jumped in late. I think some might have been surprised when you see Austin Osberry, obviously Verge's son, a legacy, pick Auburn, Jadarian Rim flips to Auburn. But then there's Jordan Allen and LaTerrence Welsh to kind of fill those two spots. I might be oversimplifying it, so you correct me if I'm wrong. But let's start with Jordan Allen. I think everybody knows LCA has been such a powerhouse, but what is it about him that made him attractive?
He's stepped up in some big spots, and going back to his junior year, the tail end of that state championship run, Sage Ryan had just gone down with an injury in the quarterfinals, and they have a state semifinal matchup down in New Orleans against Newman and Arch Manning and A.J. Johnson and all those guys, one of the better teams that Newman's had in quite some time, and thought they could finally break through and get to the Superdome. And then Jordan steps up and holds A.J., I think, catchless in 13 or 14 targets. And so that really kind of helped blow him up a little bit. And then he really became one of the more heavily recruited prospects around the state in terms of how many offers he was reeling in early on in this calendar year. And LSU was one that, again, I thought LSU was going to come in and extend that offer pretty early. Even looking back to that same weekend in January when Landon Arrieta kind of blew up, that was the weekend that LaTerrence Welsh committed to Corey Raymond over the phone, and Jordan Allen was kind of right there by his side. And there was a conversation where Corey told Jordan, you know, Jordan LT, you know, we're coming for the other guy too. We're coming for you next. And so I thought that was kind of a matter of time, but the more offers came, LSU still wasn't there until the very end, again, with some shakeup and a new staff and all those things. And he's had some big moments and some big games of that ilk, kind of like the Newman game that I mentioned. He's a little bit more of a solid, thick-built, physical-type kid. He's not going to get out there and run a 4.35 or 4.440, but he will kind of get up in your face, and he's helped in run support a lot in LCA's past few years because they play the Notre Dames of Crowley and some of those teams, Acadiana, who they actually beat this year. So he's had to show that part of his game as much as anything else, but he'll move around, probably play some nickel, maybe some safety, and show a little bit of that versatility.
Jerit Roser is with us, Tiger Details, talking about some of these guys. Now, what about LaTerrence Welsh as well? Is it the way I kind of led you in there with Jordan Allen, Jerit, is it fair to say that you take Allen Welsh as sort of a flip for Rim and Austin Osberry? Am I oversimplifying it there?
You might be oversimplifying it, and okay. I think they'll probably go get some more in this class in that secondary with how depleted numbers-wise they've been in recent years, and obviously you see now Elias Ricks heading to Tuscaloosa. But LT was a guy, LaTerrence was a guy that stood out to the former staff and Corey Raymond and became a priority pretty early on. And so LaTerrence had committed in January and had seemed like he was heading that direction even earlier. He just kind of timed the commitment with his mother's birthday and announced at the end of January. But he's a guy that you'll have some people talk about as maybe a top five or six player in this class in the state this year. I think he's pretty widely regarded as top 10 or 12. And he's a guy that fits that mold of the type of true corner that Corey Raymond has brought into LSU through the years. He's long, he's fast, he's physical, will get up in your face and really create problems for wide receivers with that length and that wiry strength, and is a fantastic kid and leader that a lot of other members of this class have kind of looked up to throughout it, and so a nice character guy in this class as well.
Jerit Roser is with us here for a couple of more minutes. If you had to look at this class with 13 signees, and forgive me as we speak right now, I don't know if Miles Frazier's letter is in, or I guess he can't sign a letter of intent, right? He can only sign one, so I guess he just waits to enroll. So 13, they count Frazier as 14. When you look at this class, where do you see either the strength, or, you know, people always like, where's the hidden gem, the diamond in the rough? Where do you see that in this class?
I think the big talking point coming out of yesterday and now with the addition of Frazier through the portal is you had a hit on offensive line in 2022. They've had a really difficult time recruiting that position group at the same level that they are typically able to recruit others. And part of that is because there aren't as many high caliber offensive line prospects at an LSU level in Louisiana year in, year out, as there are with a wide receiver or a defensive line or defensive back. And this year, you see the four guys that signed yesterday. Those were all people that Coach O and Brad Davis and company identified and really wanted to get after, because it was a strong year in state for offensive line prospects to kind of make up for some of the misses or smaller classes in that position group in recent years. And so to hit on all those guys, have a guy like a Will Campbell, someone who you're super familiar with, and Emory Jones over there at Catholic High, as well as Bo Bordelon. He's a little bit more of a project than those other two. And then Fitzgerald West Jr., who has really developed quite a bit over the last few years and now gets locked in on one position at the college level and grow into an interior lineman on the offensive side. I think that stands out certainly, because it's been a few years since you've seen even four offensive linemen sign in the same class of that caliber for LSU. And now you have the transfer guy, and I think you'll continue to see another one or two join that mix moving forward.
There's two more I want to ask you about. So you mentioned Fitzgerald West. Is he a guy – so that was – correct me if I'm wrong, Jared, but this is a guy who was camping as a defensive lineman. They said, hey, will you go snap the ball? They offered him basically on the spot. Is that a guy that you think transitions seamlessly to the offensive line at this level?
I do. He's someone that actually his junior year of high school, I talked to some of his high school coaches after going to visit. It might have been the eve of Sage Ryan's announcement, and that's why I was out in Lafayette that night, was one last talk with Sage before he announces, is it going to be Alabama or LSU? And Fitz had played some both ways throughout his career, but had really been more focused on the defensive line. And watching him that night, it was probably one of the better performances I'd seen him have in his high school career as a guy who's started since eighth grade. And he really impressed me in his frame. He's not necessarily the height that I think LSU typically brings in some defensive tackles, but he fit in well in that guard or center type role. And I talked to his coaches about the potential that he could be an offensive lineman at the next level. And he'd always been a little bit more hesitant to it, but he continued to work through the spring. And then that same first weekend that everything opened back up in June, showed up to LSU's camp again and was literally running back and forth. He'd have his defensive rep, and then while everyone else on the defensive line was heading back to the defensive line, he would flip sides and then turn and snap the ball and block somebody, and was dominant both directions. And O was kind of losing his mind a little bit, getting really excited and pumping his fist and all that. And so you knew that offer was coming. And then he focused that much more on offensive line this fall, continued to develop. And so he's still going to pick up some things every year moving forward. He's been split quite a bit throughout his high school career, but I think he's going to really fit in very well in that role. And the more work he gets fine tuning things on just that side of the ball, I think you'll see him be a nice asset in the middle of the offensive line.
Jared, tell us what happened with Ty G. Hill.
Yeah, Ty G is someone that was on LSU's radar really early. He'd been kind of a high-profile prospect from early on in his career at Carr. Started getting a lot of playing time as an underclassman and catching some attention. Really agile defensive tackle. You'll see a lot of spin moves from him in the middle of that defensive line. That's kind of his signature, is putting some guys on skates a little bit with his quickness for his size. And he ends up sticking with it throughout. There was some question marks late whether he would still end up in this class, particularly after the coaching change. But as they lined up at Carr yesterday with the three Cougars signing their letters of intent, he stuck with LSU and looks like he's really excited to get up to Baton Rouge still.
All right, before you go, last thing, your time so much appreciated. He's on Twitter at Jerit Roser. Y'all give him a follow. Great stuff, Tiger Details, part of the Rivals Network. What's next? If they're at 14 now, who are the names that we're keeping an eye on, and what do you see as needs and a realistic way to finish this class in February if you're putting a bow on it?
Yeah, I think you'll still see them continue to go after some of those same positions that we're talking about in the trenches that I don't know that they're necessarily done. Julian Armella, a standout offensive lineman in Florida, had kind of leaned more toward Florida State late in this process, ends up not signing yesterday, and so it leaves the door open for him to potentially join this class. Two really huge names in-state, Jacoby Matthews, the standout safety and really everything for Ponchatoula the last few years, is someone that I honestly, in my rankings for Prep Red Zone Louisiana, where I actually have kind of control over the rankings instead of just feeding some input to Sam from the Louisiana guys, I've had Jacoby as my top-rated prospect right over Will Campbell and Walker Howard for most of this year. And so he's that type of guy. He's another five-star standout. And then watching what happens with this running back situation will be interesting to me. There were three backs that kind of separated themselves in this class for a lot of this recruiting cycle. Le'Veon Moss from here in Baton Rouge at Estruma signed yesterday with Texas A&M. Trevante Citizen, a one-time LSU commit before the coaching changes, has remained available, and Frank Wilson's kind of working that angle and seeing about bringing Trevante back into this class. Obviously, a lot of familiarity there from Lake Charles College Prep, so right down the road from Frank the last year or so. And then Trevor Etienne, younger brother of Travis Etienne, is also waiting his decision and is someone that Frank Wilson is super familiar with. And so I look for the Tigers to really try and get at least one or two of those guys and at least one or two backs overall in this class. And that's kind of a position that I've zeroed in on and really interested to see how it shakes out.
Jerit Roser, Tiger Details, part of the Rivals Network. He's on Twitter at Jerit Roser, J-E-R-I-T-R-O-S-E-R. Y'all go give him a follow. Great info, man. Appreciate some time. Thanks for making it work with us today, bud.
You got it, man. Always a pleasure. Appreciate y'all.
All right, man. We'll talk soon. Good stuff there from Jerit. Like I mentioned, there's just a few people I know that cover preps in the state of Louisiana at a deeper level than that guy. So when you see a lot of these guys jump in the class late, you're wondering what's up with them. Like, that's a really good resource to go to. So appreciate Jerit for a couple of minutes. All right, it's after further review. Let me knock out a quick break. By the way, the new Advocate beat writer for LSU, Leah Vann, is going to be in studio with us at the top of hour two, so about 30 minutes from right now. I haven't met her yet, so looking forward to that. Get her take on what it's been like. She got dropped into this job 2.5 months ago. Like, boom, coach fired. Welcome to Baton Rouge. Anyway, but we'll look forward to having Leah in studio with us in a little bit. We'll go around the SEC when we continue next.
AFR.
If you need dinner plans, Ichiban, always a great option. You know that. Essen near Perkins, voted by you, best sushi, best hibachi, in the best of 225 awards. You can go to ichibanbr.com, search the menu. You can go to ichibanbr.com and order online. Maybe you want to get your sushi to go today. No worries. Order online, pay online, pull up into the spot, call the number. They'll bring it out to you. You can have a completely contactless experience at Ichiban. Essen near Perkins. And of course, from our friends at Ichiban, their latest concept is Boru Ramen in Electric Depot on Government Street. Authentic Japanese ramen. Handmade noodles on premise right there at Boru. Electric Depot on Government Street in the heart of Mid-City. All-weather patio dining. So you want to have an indoor or outdoor experience. Fast, casual, affordable, delicious. It is Boru Ramen. Try something new. Try Boru.
Your path to recovery. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
Thanks, you're ready. Veggies in the window.
Barbecue guys, born to grill.
Pops, how many steaks you want?
Yo, Jake here from Patient Plus Urgent Care Clinic, reminding you they now have 8 convenient locations across the Baton Rouge area, open from 9 a.m. until 9 p.m. And if you're looking for that COVID test for holiday travel or you have a holiday event coming up, they are the place for you, as well as a flu shot starting to creep up here during flu season. So if you need that shot, make sure you get that. They now have some available through December. You can find more information on their website, patientplusuc.com. That's Patient Plus Urgent Care Clinic. Get in and get better.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And now 0% for 60 months on Ford F-150s. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
To the heroes who are working tirelessly to care for our communities, we thank you. We will never forget the countless hours you dedicated on the front lines, choosing to risk your own health to fight for our friends, neighbors, and family members.
I mean, you guys are out on the front lines fighting it.
We are grateful for your heroic acts and unwavering spirit. Together, we are overcoming this adversity and make our state healthier and more vibrant again. Ochsner Health.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
Twin Peaks and Coors Light present the College Bowl Pick'em. Correctly picked the winner of all bowl games listed to win $2,021 cash. Go to 1045ESPN.com to register. Make your picks, beginning with the Bowls on Tuesday, December 21st. Second place wins a two-night stay at the Beau Rivage, and third place gets $200 in Twin Peaks gift cards. The College Bowl Pick'em, presented by Twin Peaks, scores light in 1045 ESPN, Baton Rouge.
I feel like I just heard that.
I just read it, that's why.
Well, before you read it.
I don't know what you're talking about. Nah.
We had the recorded spot. For those that weren't listening to the Baton Rouge radio at the time, the recorded spot of that aired just now before you did that. But good. Back-to-back advertising sometimes can be effective. Have you filled out your bracket yet? Not a bracket, I guess, just all of your bowl pickers.
No, I haven't even registered. I have to get finished registering. I got that email and then kind of flagged it and forgot about it.
So, I mean, the first bowl game is tomorrow.
Yeah. Right, but you make your picks beginning with the bowl games on Tuesday, December 21st.
Oh, maybe I should have listened to either of the spots.
Yeah,
that just
how about that?
So what you're telling me is I have some time.
You have time. I'm guessing you haven't filled out yours either then.
I've registered, have not picked the games yet. I need to get Erica to do it also. That would actually be fun.
That would be fun.
The Bahamas Bowl is mañana, 11 a.m. Central.
Saw Toledo in Northern Illinois. Toledo in Middle Tennessee.
And then also the Tail Greeter Cure Bowl is tomorrow. That is Northern Illinois against Coastal Carolina.
Shots.
So we have some games tomorrow. I'd love bowl season. I know a lot of guys opt out. I don't really care. I don't expect players to play in meaningless bowl games that are basically set up for people in ugly blazers to get paid. I don't care. But I do love football, and so if there's college football on TV, I'm for it, and I'll watch, even if there's rosters of like 45 people, which you'll probably see for some of these, determining what motivation is there. And the same can be said for LSU as well. If you missed it today, Trey Palmer entered the transfer portal after his three seasons in Baton Rouge. Shea Dixon noted 9 wide receivers now on the LSU roster. Landon Ibieta did sign yesterday, so it would be 10. And then we'll see if they get more receivers in this class, which most certainly they will. And could there be more attrition there? Probably. But it underscores something I've been saying to you for weeks now. There's going to be more transfers. There's going to be bowl opt-outs. And there's going to be guys academically ineligible. Like, LSU is going to have a tough time filling a bus for this game. But let's get wild. Let's watch some Texas Bowl action on January the 4th in Houston. Let's chug beers with Sean Salisbury.
Matt O'Dowd.
Matt O'Dowd era.
The Matt O'Dowd Bowl.
I'm not going to lie to you. Like, I know Sean got us all pumped up about the Matt O'Dowd Bowl. I would really love to see Jontre Kirkland play quarterback.
That'd be pretty cool, too.
That's the thing that I would love to see. Let that dude go run around, be athletic, sling it a little bit. I would really like to see that a lot, actually. Some triple option maybe working in there. Counter sweeps.
Avery Atkins throwing 2 passes this year.
No, I just want to see him block. Okay. I just want to see him block. You put him on the edge, maybe as a lead back. Yeah, dude was an all-state safety in Alabama. Let him go blow people up. I would be for that, but not a quarterback, no. Okay, let's go around the SEC.
Around the SEC, presented by Gulf Coast Office Products, excellence in imaging solutions, the Florida Gators.
A Florida quarterback, Emory Jones, is planning to enter the transfer portal. This is odd, though. He is going to play in the Gasparilla Bowl. Seriously, he's going to play in the Gasparilla Bowl.
Why?
I don't know. Once strap it on one more time.
I'm leaving, but after this.
I don't play this game, and then I'm going to bounce.
Then I'm leaving. I'm out.
Deuces. It's like, no, I can't use that analogy. It's like when the couple breaks up, but you hook up one more time before you really call it quits.
Yeah.
That's what it is. He's got 2 years of eligibility remaining. Started 11 games this season for the Gators. Anthony Richardson had knee surgery, so he's not available for the Gasparilla Bowl. So Emory Jones can play in the bowl game against UCF and then bounce.
The Auburn Tigers.
Bradarius Ham. He's bouncing from Auburn, but he's not going to another school. He's going pro. He spent 5 years there on the plains, but because of COVID, he has another year if he wants it, but he don't want it. He's going to go pro. Don't blame him. Second member of Auburn's 2 deep on the offensive line to leave. Sean Manning transferred to Kentucky. Ham has appeared in 34 games, starting 20 of them in his Auburn career.
The Arkansas Razorbacks.
Redshirt freshman wide receiver Darren Turner has entered the transfer portal. This is an interesting one. 6'3", 205. He was a 4-star recruit. He was the number 215 overall player in the country, the number 39 wide receiver when he signed with Arkansas. He picked the Hogs over. He had interest from Bama, Clemson, LSU, Auburn, Miami. He had big-time interest, and in 2 years never appeared in a game for Arkansas, and now he's leaving. And only one game on the hardwood last night in the conference. Ole Miss on Wednesday at home beat Middle Tennessee by 10, 62-52. So Ole Miss gets back in the win column. It was Nizer Brooks who had 12 points all in the second half to lead Ole Miss to the win over Middle Tennessee. He sat out the final 7 minutes of the first half with 2 fouls but finished on a hot streak. And freshman Deshaun Ruffin, the program's first McDonald's All-American, played his first game since fracturing his right hand in the season opener, had 12 points, 9 of them in the first half. All right, there you have it. That is Around the SEC presented by Gulf Coast Office Products. Remember, courtside for charity. I'll keep reminding you about that. Our friend Trey Beal over at Gulf Coast Office Products taking four games, his courtside seats for 4 games at the center court on the floor for 4 games, and they're raffling off those tickets for charity, $20 per entry. And you can enter right now at 1045ESPN.com. Right there on the flipper, you see the courtside for charity tab. It's $20 per chance, or you can get 6 chances for $100 or 15 chances for $250, I believe. And the 4 games that are being raffled off, December 28th against Cleveland, January 6th against the Golden State Warriors. That's right. You could sit on the floor to watch Steph Curry. The Clippers on January 13th, the Rockets on February the 8th. All info is there at 1045ESPN.com. And at the end of the raffle, after all the four, so February the 3rd will be the drawing for the final game. All of the money raised will be divided among 4 charities. St. Lillian Academy, which is where my son Drew attends. the Arc of Baton Rouge, Greater Baton Rouge Food Bank, and Alzheimer's Services of the Capital Area. So great work there by Trey Beal, who's offering up his tickets for a great cause, and we're happy to promote it. So courtside for charity, 1045ESPN.com. I have it pinned on my Facebook and Twitter accounts as well, if you want to get the link there to go buy your tickets. All right, it's after further review. Speaking of the Pelicans, an improbable win last night. If you have not heard it yet, you will hear it next. It's AFR.
AFR.
Brought to you by Pinnacle Exterior Construction, PECBuilt.com, PECBuilt.com. You can see pictures of their beautiful work there at the website, PECBuilt.com, or their Instagram. If you want to check it out, you can see their custom pools, their fences, decks, bulkheads, outdoor kitchens, even their commercial projects. Like maybe you're a neighborhood, you have a neighborhood pool that for your entire neighborhood, like at a at your community pool, they do those as well. You can see pictures of all their beautiful work online at PECBuilt.com, PECBuilt.com. It's Pinnacle Exterior Construction. Turn your boring backyard into a showplace and start with that phone call. They'll come out to your property. They'll look at your land, your area, give you some ideas, brainstorm with you, and then you can get on the schedule, break ground, and get cruising toward having that custom pool when the weather's nice again. It's Pinnacle Exterior Construction, 757-6138 or PECBuilt.com.
There it is, the extra mile on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
Starting in 1974, Central Plumbing has served Baton Rouge and surrounding areas for all of their plumbing needs. Through these tough and trying times, we want you to remember that the Payne family is here to continue to support and serve you. As a multi-generational business, there is no job that is too big or too small. Residential, commercial, industrial, hospitality, we're here for anything you need. 24/7, 365, give us a call, 225-925-8552.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And now 0% for 60 months. Gonna do right by.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com.
ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
As always, shout out to Relief Windows and ReliefWindows.com. Windows, doors, siding, Relief Windows and ReliefWindows.com. Energy efficient replacement windows, beautiful entry doors, hardy plank and vinyl siding, ReliefWindows.com. I mentioned windows because a window last night in Oklahoma City got abused. They might have to call Relief Windows to replace it after what Devontae Graham did last night. Relief Windows and ReliefWindows.com. Did you see the end of the Pelicans game? Well, let me refresh it. Muse, what's today's date? Do I have this correctly? Today's date is the
16th. December 16th. Yeah.
December 16th. So it's not yet. We're 9 days from Christmas.
Correct.
So we're 9 days from the start of the NBA season?
Well, not officially. It did start earlier, yeah.
No, officially. The start of the season officially is Christmas Day. So the Pelicans are having exhibitions right now.
Is no, that these what this count. Is? These count. These are real games.
Well, it's not Christmas yet, so they can't be actual real games that count.
The season started.
No, they can't. Yeah, that can't be the case. It doesn't start till Christmas.
Yeah, it starts before.
So
actually.
The Pelicans were having an exhibition last
night. It's real. Real game.
They were having a real exhibition in Oklahoma City against the Thunder, and there was this sort of improbable moment where Shai Gilgeous-Alexander hits a 37-footer while being heavily guarded by Garrett Temple, who might have been actually trying to foul him, hits this improbable three-pointer to tie the ball game with 1.4 seconds left. It appeared destined for overtime, and then Devontae Graham, courtesy of Joe Myers, Bally Sports.
Didn't get him, and give Shai Gilgeous-Alexander credit as Devontae sends it. Oh! Gets it! The game winner!
Oh, wow!
Devontae Graham stuns him in Oklahoma City.
Just how you drew it up!
After the Pels were shocked by Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. Incredible!
It was, by the way, the first... it was the longest game-winning buzzer beat. I can't believe ESPN Stats and Info has it. I can't believe they have this. Are you ready for this?
Let's go.
Here's the improbability, okay? Graham's shot was the longest game-winning buzzer beater in the last 25 years. It beat a 50-footer by Tyreek Evans for Memphis in 2010. Okay? That was the previous long in the last 25 years. So when Shai Gilgeous-Alexander hit the 30-footer to tie the score... This is according to Second Spectrum, and tip of the cap to our buddy Andrew Lopez of ESPN.com because he found all these ridiculous numbers. According to Second Spectrum, who are apparently a bunch of nerds who have nothing better to do than this, Gilgeous-Alexander shot had a 14.1% chance of going in. Graham's shot had a 3.5% chance of going in. The combined chance for both to go in, 0.5%. Like what you saw last night is the definition of improbability. Also, it was the first game in the past 25 years to feature multiple game-tying or go-ahead shots from 30-plus feet inside the final 5 seconds of the game. And as you might imagine, our buddy, Todd Graffanini, lost his mind on the Pelicans radio broadcast.
Giddy going to inbound at sideline left on the hash mark. Nikhil in his face. Giddy will float it into Shea. And he throws up a three. From 37 feet, nothing but net. Temple was trying to foul him. They didn't call it. Inbound to Devontae, three-quarter court, good if it goes. He banked it in! He banked it in! He banked it in! The Pelicans have won by the most improbable shot you can even think of. Back-to-back improbable shots. And the Pels win it 113-110, and they are running off the floor and getting the heck out of Dodge.
As they should.
What a great call by Graf. They're running off the floor and getting the heck out of Dodge. And, of course, there is always the thrill of victory and the agony of defeat, courtesy of Bally Sports OKC.
Giddy's got to get it in. No timeouts. The ball is inbounded to Shea. Temple did not foul. Count the bucket for the win.
So good.
He was kind of excited.
Even the Thunder broadcasters were kind of excited about, like,
we lost.
In that moment, how could you not sort of be taken aback by the emotional high of what had just happened? And if you're watching, pull this up again, Paulie. Like, the craziest part about it is BI actually set an incidental screen. Like, he was so, even after the game, he was so shell-shocked that he was kind of after Shai Gilgeous-Alexander shot, he was kind of standing around looking. He didn't even get the play call on the inbound. Thank God Graham did. Look, he's just standing. B.I.'s just standing there, and he set a screen for Graham to go around and get the spacing to get the shot off with 1.4. So a lot of improbable things happened there, but a heads-up play there by Graham. Great. Even if it was an exhibition, it's great to win.
It counted.
No, it's not Christmas yet.
Doesn't matter. That's not when the season actually – no, it's not.
This doesn't count.
Oh, Lord.
Real game start on Christmas, 9 days away. It's AFR.
AFR.
Brought to you by South Point Volkswagen, southpointvw.com, new and certified pre-owned. In Baton Rouge and online at southpointvw.com, southpointvw.com. The 2022s are going to be arriving, so got to get rid of the 2021s. 0% APR for 36 months on all 2021 models. 1.99% APR right now for 36 months on all pre-owned Volkswagen models. Again, I tell you all the time, new or certified pre-owned, South Point Volkswagen. Also, sign then drive. Zero down, zero due at signing, no first month's payment, no security deposit. You sign your name and you drive away in a gorgeous vehicle from South Point Volkswagen. 9 IIHS top safety picks, the highest safety designation you can have. So safe vehicles that are stylish, luxurious, the great German engineering, manufactured right here in the USA at their Tennessee plant without the cost. It's South Point Volkswagen. Airline just north of Highland, South Point Volkswagen. What's your direction?
If you're in a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
You know, our topic today is about savings. What is savings?
Hancock Whitney isn't just a bank for our clients. We're investing in our hometowns, making life better for everyone. So keep dreaming. We've got your back.
Thanks, you're ready. Veggies in the window.
Barbecue guys, born to grill.
Pops, how many steaks you want?
I had to leave my parents. I had to move schools. I don't know anyone here. Everything keeps changing. Why is this happening to me? I'm sure glad you're here.
Change a child's story. There's a child in foster care waiting for a volunteer like you.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And now 0% for 60 months on Ford F-150s. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care. It's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Front to Back Boat Service has been family owned and operated for 30 years. And the Sherman family is NMEA certified. That's the National Marine Electronics Association at Front to Back. They are committed to improving the safety and technology of marine electronics through installer training, interface standards. And look, the fall and the winter, it's the perfect time to do that yearly maintenance you've been putting off. Get those parts you've been wanting. So schedule your appointment today at Front to Back North Airway off of Airline Highway.
I'm Doug Brown. At least until next Tuesday, all 32 NFL teams will go into more intensive COVID-19 protocols. So far, the NFL is not planning any delays or postponements with the rise in positive tests. The Washington outbreak increases to 21 players today. Six more Bears players and all three coordinators are now in COVID-19 protocols. Tonight, the 9-4 Chiefs play the 8-5 Chargers in Inglewood. The search is on for the next Jaguars head coach after the firing of Urban Meyer. ESPN's Lewis Riddick says the team needs to make the right hire for quarterback Trevor Lawrence.
That has to be, without a doubt, priority number one in terms of who Shai Khan interviews going forward. Making sure they have a plan to make sure that this young man reaches his potential. Because if you screw that up, I mean, man, you're not going to get many more opportunities like that.
Lewis Riddick on Get Up. ESPN's Adam Schefter reports Lions tight end TJ Hawkinson will miss the rest of the season after thumb surgery today. Hawkinson is the Lions' leading receiver this year.
Getting paid up to 2 days early with direct deposit is another reason banking with Capital One is one of the easiest decisions in the history of decisions. That's banking reimagined. What's in your wallet? Terms apply. See CapitalOne.com/bank. Capital One N.A., member FDIC.
Matt Moscona.
I'm very important.
After further review.
Say one more time.
After further review with Matt Moscona.
And here we go.
ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge Studios.
Let's ride!
Hour two, off we go. Welcome aboard. Glad you're with us. AFR, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. Matt?
I appreciate it, bud. Have a good one.
Paul O'Neill?
They're chanting Paul O'Neill's name.
Muso. And Mr. Toby Tomplay. All right, we're here. Glad you are as well. Get out there and make it a good one. I'll get you the Saints injury report about 15 minutes from right now. We do have to talk about Elias Ricks picking Alabama. Trey Palmer transferring out. That's coming at the bottom of this hour. Next hour, my Triplett of ESPN.com will be with us. So glad to have you here. Very glad to welcome for the first time onto AFR the Advocate's newest LSU beat writer, Leah Vann, who is in studio with us. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thanks for having me.
It's our pleasure. Thank you so much for coming in. She's on Twitter at LVann_sports if you want to give her a follow. Okay. You went to Texas undergrad.
Yes.
You were living in Fort Worth. You get the LSU job. They drop you in here the second week in October. And boom, a coach gets fired. So welcome to Baton Rouge.
So that's a little bit of an inaccuracy. I am from Fort Worth, okay. But I've actually moved around quite a bit in this industry. So I was actually covering the Iowa Hawkeyes. Before I was here, yeah, it's a lot colder there.
Welcome to a place where right. You don't have to wear a like Stay Puft jacket in December.
Yeah, no, it's fabulous being back in the South. Obviously, I grew up in Texas. I went to University of Texas for undergrad, went to Northwestern for graduate school. But yeah, I was covering Big Ten football, and I got the call actually the week of the Iowa-Iowa State game, which is like the biggest thing that's ever happened in Iowa, where they were top 10 teams at the time.
Oh, yeah, the Cy-Hawk Trophy.
Yeah. And I got the call and they're like, yeah, we're going to make your life more stressful. How would you like to cover LSU football and baseball? And I was like, sure. Maybe, I don't know. I got to go cover this game.
Wait, so you're like, it was Saturday. Like you were literally the day you're covering the game.
It was literally Friday that when I was driving to Ames to go cover the game. Wow. And I drove straight to a brewery and I met up with my two guy friends. I said, y'all, I got something to tell y'all, and I don't know what to do.
I love that you went to a brewery. That's where this started. It's fantastic.
Literally like, the start of it.
So you decided to take the job. Was it a same parent company? It can't be a same parent company because no. It's obviously the Advocate's locally owned.
No. It's funny. I knew the sports editor for a couple of years now. I met him at one of our sports writing conventions because we're all nerds. And, you know, the guy, you know, Brooks Cabina and I went to school together. And as you know, he was a beat writer here. And he left the job. And I said, congrats on, you know, your job covering the Houston Texans. And he said, my job's open. And I said, interesting. Okay. And then I asked the editor, I was like, so when are you going to make this hire? And he's like, you interested? And I was like, yeah. I mean, naturally it's the SEC, bigger paper, bigger market. I'm a lot closer to Texas, a lot closer to home. So it was, I'm not going to say it was a no brainer because I had a great time covering Iowa, but, it was obviously the right choice.
So you said you moved around a bunch of where else. So take me just through, like if I say, all right, give me the elevator pitch of the career path. So you go to school at UT, you go to Northwestern grad school, then where?
I don't know how much time we have on this radio show.
That's a 3-hour show. We're an hour and 5 minutes
in. If you've got time, I've got quite a big story. Okay. But yeah, I went to Texas for undergrad and I'm actually majored in biology. I thought I was going to go to medical school because long story short, I'm a cancer survivor of about 10 years now.
Phenomenal.
But yeah, I realized about my junior year of college that my one true love was sports writing. I was covering track and field for the Daily Texan and I absolutely loved it. I've always been a big sports fan. I grew up a Cowboys fan, Longhorns fan. I know LSU fans are going to shoot me for that.
That's quite all right.
And yeah, I've always been an athlete. I played volleyball and I ran track in high school. And so I thought, okay, I'll take a journalism class, see how this goes. I took one journalism class. I applied to internships, but you're not qualified for internships without experience.
Right.
So I applied for full-time jobs. And my first job was actually in Iowa, up in Mason City, Iowa, which if y'all don't know, it is 2 hours south of the Twin Cities.
I'm actually very familiar. Randomly, I did a college internship in southern Minnesota around Mankato, Blue Earth, that whole area.
Yeah.
And so many times when driving through cornfields, like I ended up crossing the border into Iowa. So I'm actually very familiar with where
Albert Lee area. Oh, yeah. Yeah, there you go.
All of it. Yes. I'm very, very familiar with that whole area.
No one else in the United States really is, but yeah.
Except the people that are there or people who sold books door to door in the summer of 2002 like I did.
No, yeah. So I was there for a year. I covered high school sports, you know, the typical like rite of passage for sports writers.
Sure.
And covered everything. They had summer high school baseball. They had football. They had wrestling, which was my first time covering wrestling. Yikes. And I even covered everything from like dirt track racing to like old people bowling. So there was that.
That's so good.
And then my next job was in Steamboat Springs, Colorado at the Steamboat Pilot. And today I was the sports editor and photographer there. So I was covering alpine skiing, Nordic combined, ski jumping, and then your typical high school sports. So like football and basketball and volleyball. And so that was fun, but I knew if I was there, this is not going to get me my football job. Mm-hmm. You know, like it's fun being in a ski town. But I wanted to cover college or professional football. So I went back to school to finally get that major in journalism at Northwestern, which if you don't know, is a big sports media program.
Absolutely.
J.A. Adonde is in charge. My professor was Melissa Isaacson. And, so you get to really immerse yourself in it. Of course, halfway through, there was a pandemic, and there still is a pandemic. Yeah. And so that kind of made the program a little bit tougher. But, you know, we did get to go to L.A. beforehand. I covered PGA Genesis Invitational, covered a Lakers game, covered a Kings game in L.A., got to cover some stuff in Chicago area. And, yeah, my first job, ironically, out of graduate school was covering the Iowa Hawkeyes. And I had to tell everybody, I was like, yes, I am moving to Iowa for the second time on purpose. And they were like, why can't you get a job in Texas? And I was like, do y'all know like who has those jobs in Texas? Do you think they're going to retire anytime soon? Because no one's going to retire anytime soon. If you work in the South and you work in sports media, you're set. You're happy. And so, I got this job. It was also the only sports job that was open. But it was a great job, you know, covering Big Ten football. I started that in January and didn't even get through half the season and I get the call to come here. So here I am.
It is a very transient business as you were evidence of in a very, very early part of your career too, which is awesome. So welcome to Louisiana, which is awesome. Do you have some time? Because I want to do. I do want to talk some LSU stuff with you if you have time. But before we do that, you mentioned that you were a cancer survivor. Mm-hmm. If you don't mind me saying, I saw on your Twitter the Make-A-Wish post that you made.
Yeah.
So can you elaborate a little? I mean, to whatever you're comfortable talking about.
No, I'm a pretty open book. Of course, when you have cancer or anything that's life-threatening happen to you, you get calls from the Make-A-Wish Foundation. They said, hey, you know, what's going to be your wish? And my first wish was to go to the Super Bowl, but it was the NFL lockout thing that was happening. So they were like, not sure.
2011, yeah.
Yeah, they were not sure if that was going to happen. And so then when the lockout ended, they were like, you still want to go to the Super Bowl? I was like, well, the problem is if I go to the Super Bowl, I'm probably not going to meet my favorite team, the Dallas Cowboys. So I was like, I might as well. I was like, I actually would rather meet the Dallas Cowboys.
A very realistic Cowboys fan.
Yeah, I am a very realistic
Cowboys fan. That's odd. A little outlier.
No, it's, I don't know. I'm a realistic Cowboys fan, realistic Longhorns fan, you know.
Okay.
The sports writer in me is critical. But yeah, so they said,
okay.
They didn't tell me when they were going to grant it, but they made me the face of their Macy's Make-A-Wish Foundation campaign where I encourage kids at school, at our like elementary schools, to write letters to Santa, which would donate money to Make-A-Wish. So they invite me on Good Morning Texas. They're like, okay, just tell your story and like tell us about the work. And then all of a sudden they're like, well, Leah, just today we thought we'd grant your wish. And here's Jay Novacek to come grant your wish. You're going to meet Dallas Cowboys. And I freaked out. And of course they've got Santa there. And he's like, they're like, oh, well, you're more excited to meet Jay Novacek than Santa, which honestly, who would it be if you're a Cowboys fan? But also I'm Jewish. So I was like, well, I'm Jewish. And like, the whole Jewish community was like, Leah, put us on the map. Let's go.
That is fantastic. So there's you with Jay Novacek. There's the tweet. And then there's you with Tony Romo, for those that want to see it.
Yeah.
At @LVann_sports, Leah Vann, new LSU beat writer for The Advocate, hanging out with us here for a couple of minutes. You good to sit tight for a few more minutes?
Yeah.
Okay, Leah's going to stay with us. We'll jump into kind of what it was like covering this coaching search and then a signing day, and which is going to go right into baseball, which he's actually super passionate about, which is awesome. So more with Leah Vann. We continue. It's AFR.
AFR.
Take 60 seconds to remind you about Clegg's Nursery, 4 locations in the greater Baton Rouge area, Seguin near Airline, LA 16 in Denham, Mid-City on Donmore, and the Garden Center on Greenwell Springs. Tell you every day, buy local, shop local. Love that we're partnering with so many great local businesses, because businesses like Clegg's have been so invested in our community for decades. In Clegg's case, it's been more than 60 years. Listen, the holidays are here. Our family has a big, it's actually Erica's family's big family Christmas party at our house this weekend. Of course, we're going to Clegg's, load up on poinsettias to decorate inside and out. Maybe you need that gift for the hard to shop for person on your list. Maybe they're a green thumb. Clegg's gift card, wind chimes, bird feeders, so many great options at Clegg's Nursery. Any of the 4 locations in the greater Baton Rouge area, find the location nearest you, get on and get your Christmas list taken care of. Buy local, shop local for more than 60 years. Go see our friends at Clegg's Nursery and be sure to tell them Matt sent you in. To Clegg's Nursery.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Corvo Toyota's ending the year with our annual Toyota-thon event. Come on down to Happy Town to pre-order your new Toyota today. We also have a large number of pre-owned vehicles on location. Come celebrate Toyota-thon with us at Corvell Toyota in Opelousas, Happy Town, USA.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice? As I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
Tonight, we invite you to celebrate life, wherever and whenever you can.
understanding that time is never on our side. Instead, gather up your friends tonight and share a few stories and laughs over a good bottle of wine. Or maybe a family meal that gives everyone a chance to reconnect and remember what's really important, whether it's for a birthday, an anniversary, or simply to remind someone special that they are loved. Ruffino's, where Louisiana comes to celebrate life.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare for Kelly.
There it is, the extra mile. On the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like Vann's customized for work or play. With safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team. And backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
We're glad to have Leah Vann from The Advocate hanging out with us, new LSU beat writer, good enough to come in studio, kind of gave us a little bit of her backstory. You're going to get to know her. She's covering LSU football, and she'll also be the primary beat writer for LSU baseball. And you are, like, actually a really... This is very refreshing. Like, you're a big college baseball fan.
Yeah. Okay. So, like, I think I'm a recent college baseball fan. Texas has been doing well over the years, so I've been to two College World Series.
As a fan.
Yeah. I, like, just drove to Omaha and was like, yeah, why not? And I have had the best time. And, of course, I watch them on TV and stuff. So, I wouldn't list me as, like, a diehard college baseball fan, but I would say I'm a pretty good fan. Yeah.
Well, I mean, to know... College, like you know this, and our audience as well, college baseball is culturally so different. It's not the caliber of play that you can find in Major League Baseball or even Minor League Baseball, but there's so much passion surrounding it for the people that love it. And this is, I tell people all the time, Leah, like Baton Rouge is such a unique market. I mean that in the literal sense, like only one because of the population crossover with Baton Rouge and New Orleans. And you have major college and professional sports, and then the outlier is college baseball. There's nowhere else where like you can go and do sports radio and actually break down the decision of a pitching change in a middle inning of a midweek game, and people give a damn. But they do here, but that passion is really cool in college baseball. So have you gotten to meet Jay Johnson, or have you gotten to kind of get your feet wet at all in LSU baseball?
Yeah, I have. I got to meet Jay Johnson multiple times now, and I've also attended some of the scrimmages that they've had and talked to some of the players. So, I'm getting more immersed in it, like as much as I can with football and everything that is LSU football going on. I'm really looking forward to it, though. I love the passion of college baseball. I love the College World Series. I think it's so unique, and I think it's severely underrated. By fans.
It's growing. I mean, there's no doubt. And ESPN has been obviously a big push behind that. What are your I'm going to switch to LSU football in a second, but just impressions of Jay Johnson, because I mean, he's obviously in his first season and people are getting to know him as well, but so many early returns seem positive.
He's a very like calculated, regimented man. It just seems like everybody says that the workouts are brutal but also just more so like very organized. He is very organized and he's very thoughtful. You can tell when he speaks, he's like really thinking about the words that he's choosing when he's talking about different players, which I appreciate as a journalist. I love the detail. It just seems like he's got a really good, like he's got a game plan in place, but he's afraid to tell you too much or hype, like, you know, the program up too much, just because he doesn't want people to have, like, unrealistic expectations or anything like that, or it could be, you know, that good things happen. I don't know. I think he's very calculated in his approach, and he's been really nice to me, so I like him so far.
And then you're also going to cover another new coach now in Brian Kelly in the football side.
Yes.
What day did you arrive? Do you remember the date that you arrived in Baton Rouge?
I think I actually, like, arrived on October 2nd, but I think my first day was October 5th.
Okay.
Something like that.
So that was, like, the week of the Kentucky game.
Yes.
So the first game that you were, I guess, covering.
Yeah.
But you didn't go to Lexington, correct?
I didn't go to Lexington. I covered it remotely because we were still doing Zoom interviews right at that time. So, yeah, but I did cover. Like, I watched the game, and then I wrote, like, a sidebar. I don't remember what it was about, but, yeah, I wrote something.
So the first thing you wrote about was the Kentucky loss,
mm-hmm.
and then they beat Florida.
That was my first game to be at.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then they fired the coach.
Yeah.
Like, when you took the job, did you have any inkling that of what was brewing here?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. they told me when I took the job, they were like, oh, you might be covering a coaching search. And I was like, great, cool. It sounded interesting. I mean, from a journalistic standpoint, there's a lot more to learn from covering things like that, covering things like players entering the transfer portal and all the moving parts and the new coaching staff. There's a lot more to learn from that than just covering a team that is successful, I guess, mm-hmm. you know, or like doing well. I mean, I'm not saying that LSU isn't successful, they're going to a bowl game, but yeah.
Yeah, I mean, 6-6 around here isn't exactly what
I
people
know.
Are
it's
doing
not up to standard.
And it's very different than obviously Iowa there with Kirk Ferentz, who's been like, what, 22, how many years has he been? 23.
Probably.
Okay. I mean, yeah. So like that's just, he's got to be at this point the longest tenured coach in college football.
Yeah.
And maybe Nick's number two. Yeah, so very different situation. I respect you treading carefully there, but I think everyone understands. But what was it like for you being dropped in here at a new place amid something that was so chaotic for really, I mean, Leah, 6-8 weeks? I mean, it was chaotic for all of us doing this, trying to follow.
Are you trying to say it's not still chaotic?
I guess it
still feels chaotic.
It has calmed down dramatically now that Brian Kelly's in place.
Right.
And I mean, they still got staff hires they have to make, et cetera. But I mean, what was that like for you being dropped into a new place in that environment?
I mean, it was scary. It was like a little intimidating, to be honest. You know, I get a call when I'm at Walmart trying to get some groceries on a Sunday. Like, hey, there's a press conference in 2 hours, and I think it's Ed Orgeron's being fired. I was like, oh, cool.
Nice.
I mean, like, I'm just trying to get some food for my new apartment. And then I'm all of a sudden in what was the coldest press conference I have ever been in. It, like, literally the temperature was cold.
Oh, I was just like, literally colder. Okay.
Like, literally cold. And then, like, the topic is also, like, very heavy. And, you know, as a new reporter, I don't think I ended up asking a question in that one just because I was like, you know, I don't know if this is my place as the mm-hmm. person who has only been to, like, 2 or 3 press conferences before this, you know. Mm-hmm. And I think up until then, we had also been doing Zoom interviews. So the only time I had talked to Coach O was, like, over Zoom.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it was intimidating. It was kind of crazy. But then as the weeks kind of go by, it's like, you know, you're getting to know the players more. You're getting to know the coaches more, especially when we started doing things in person. It just felt like another beat, you know. And you're there to tell stories. And that's what the job is. And you're also trying to figure out who the next coach is.
Yeah. What stories do you like to tell?
You put me on the spot. I mean, I really like player profiles. I really like learning about the players. I love, like, giving people this picture of who they are as human beings outside of the game. And, you know, we all get angry at our favorite players. We all get angry at our favorite teams. But I think we need to add some empathy. And that's what I try to do when I do a player profile. So it's like, you know, I might be writing about this player that you think sucks, but let me tell you a little bit about, like, who he is and how much he works to get to where he is. And, you know, I think that stories that enlighten people, stories that humble people, can maybe help us, like, gain a clearer picture of this crazy sports landscape.
Yeah, well said. Leah Vann's with us just for a couple more minutes, a new LSU beat writer for The Advocate. You'll follow her on Twitter at LVann_sports. It's 2 N's, LVANN_sports. Early impressions of Brian Kelly?
You know, we got to talk to him for a little bit outside of the press conference too. And, you know, he was down to earth, pretty easy to talk to, pretty, like, open. Of course, we weren't really asking any hard questions in that moment. Yeah. But he remembered me from the press conference, which I was kind of glad because I had asked him a question about offensive line. And
Oh, that was your question.
Yeah, that was okay. My question.
By the way, can you play that? Here's the answer, because I actually had queued this up because I wanted to play it later to talk about Myles Frazier. This is what Brian Kelly said.
Looking at what their demeanor is, playing that offensive line position requires a profile that I like to stick with. I'm not going to get into the specifics right now. And there's a brotherhood on that offensive line that we build. And that brotherhood is real. Those guys are selfless, and they are the backbone of any great offense that I've ever coached. So if you have that kind of resume, sign up. We're looking for you.
When it comes
to development,
that's
good.
Thanks, hard work. It's a good question because we were actually going to pull that up today about Brian Kelly's offensive line. So
he seemed very confident in his abilities, which like he has the track record to be confident. I think you want confidence in a coach. The rest we'll see on the field and we'll be able to know. And as long as he answers my questions with decent detail, then I'm okay with him.
Yeah. Is this your first time in Baton Rouge when you moved here, or had you been before?
I had not been before. Okay. I had actually not driven through. I was on a party bus to spring break on Gulf Shores. And
Counts.
Yeah,
it counts.
Yeah, so I just remember we were stuck in traffic in Baton Rouge, which is very accurate.
Yes,
so
yes.
I was very familiar with the traffic. I was like, why are we stuck here? And we were all like,
Because Baton Rouge. I mean, there's days I'm like, it's 11 a.m. on a Tuesday. Why is it dead stopped on Airline Highway? It doesn't make sense, but that's because Baton Rouge infrastructure is terrible. I love my hometown, but it's awful here. Infrastructure is awful here. Let me put that. Where have you eaten so far? Everyone's going to talk about food with you.
Oh, man.
Have you gotten that yet? You have to.
Yeah, I've been to Chimes, which I've told is like a Baton Rouge staple.
Yes, yes.
Gosh, I mean, I think I went to Ruby Slipper. Is that
yes,
the breakfast
absolutely.
Place? Yeah.
It's a New Orleans place. It came
but
to Baton
here.
Rouge. Fantastic spot. Yep.
Bistro Byron.
Yeah.
In there.
All right. You're getting around.
Yeah.
This is good. So,
yeah. I want to try some whiskey cocktails at that. What's it called?
Did she say whiskey cocktails?
Yeah. I love whiskey, but there's, what is it called? I'm blanking out. It begins with an H. Is it?
The Hayride Scandal.
Yes. I want to try that place.
Do you want to be my best friend? So I mean, like, we're sponsored by Sazerac Rye.
That was not planned.
You didn't even know. Like, I am a gigantic whiskey nerd. It's really my only hobby in life anymore. I have a son and a wife, and I don't pay to go to sports. I don't hunt or fish. I collect whiskey, and I have a really, really big.
So, what's your favorite spot on the Bourbon Trail?
I have never done Bourbon Trail.
What?
Isn't that so sad?
Oh, my God. And I love it there.
And I got invited to a trip right after Thanksgiving with my two cousins who were going up there. And I mean, you're in the middle of football season. Like, they were playing A&M the next day. It was like, I couldn't leave.
No.
There's another trip going with some friends this spring in March. And I think I'm going to bite the bullet and go.
You should go.
I need to go. I mean, I desperately need to go.
I've been to Four Roses. I've been to Buffalo Trace. Buffalo Trace is impressive. It's like a town in itself. Yeah.
Buffalo Trace. So Buffalo Trace was bought by the Sazerac Company, which is a New Orleans company. I don't know if you know that, but like
I didn't know that.
The Sazerac Company is like the second biggest brand portfolio in the liquor industry, maybe second or third in the world. They own Buffalo Trace. They own everything. It's insane. But yes, that's awesome. Like, this is my new best friend. Muse, did you know that Leah, Vann, and I were best friends and have been for so long?
I didn't know that we were such good friends? I might have what I learned for the day.
There you go.
How about that?
You've learned that we have been my dear friend, Leah Vann, who has been my dear friend for a long time. Like Cooper Rush.
No, you don't know Cooper Rush.
Cooper Rush and I are very dear friends.
Like, it's a redhead thing, right?
It must be. Maybe that's what it is. What do you have against redheads,
You
Muse?
Didn't even know Cooper Rush had red hair until she just said that.
I absolutely knew that. Those of us who have known him so well for so long, they call him Coop. Don't those who know him best call him? Wow, you might not even know that. We call him Coop. Those of us who have known him so well for over all the years. Cooper Rush. Don't worry, I'll explain it to you later. All right, thank you for coming in. This was a lot of fun. I appreciate you for putting up with all of our antics. But we look forward to your work. And welcome to Baton Rouge.
Oh, thanks for having me.
It's our pleasure. That's Leah Vann, the Advocate. You can read her stuff there. And you can follow her on Twitter at LVann_sports. We'll continue. It's AFR.
AFR.
Love telling you about River City's one-hour air, where they're always on time, or you don't pay a dime. 752-0001, 752-0001. Look, go to Facebook, go to Google, read the reviews. I couldn't recommend that highly enough. Because when you've been in business for 40 years and you've stayed in business for 40 years, it's in large part because you treat people right. And that's what River City's 1 Hour Air has been able to do for four decades. Matthew Penn left this review on Facebook, said, Mr. Ronnie was so knowledgeable about his craft, he even went out of his way to show me about my AC unit that I didn't know anything about. He was wonderful. I would recommend him to anyone. Just one of many reviews that you see from River City's 1 Hour Air, and they're great technicians. 752-0001, 752-0001, nights, holidays, weekends, they always come out and never charge you extra. It's River City's 1 Hour Air. Get that heater safety check. Mention the Moscona special. They'll always save you $25 at River City's 1 Hour Air. 752-0001.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
Yo, Jake here from Patient Plus Urgent Care Clinic, reminding you they now have 8 convenient locations across the Baton Rouge area, open from 9 a.m. until 9 p.m. And if you're looking for that COVID test for holiday travel, or you have a holiday event coming up, they're the place for you, as well as a flu shot starting to creep up here during flu season. So if you need that shot, make sure you get that. They now have some available through December. You can find more information on their website, patientplusuc.com. That's Patient Plus Urgent Care Clinic. Get in and get better.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And now 0% for 60 months on Ford F-150s. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals, but many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
Crime has serious consequences, but anyone can make a mistake. If you find yourself in trouble with the law, know that you have rights, and it's okay to demand them. The law offices of O.C. Brown are here to protect you and your rights. Felony or misdemeanor, DUI or drug charge, no matter what crime you're accused of, you still have rights. Let the law offices of O.C. Brown uphold them. Call 225-343-1111, your law firm for a lifetime.
Are you a licensed contractor? There's lots of good contractors in Louisiana doing work the right way, but unfortunately, too many unlicensed contractors are working outside the licensing requirements. Working as a contractor in Louisiana requires a license for the company doing the work. The Louisiana State Licensing Board for Contractors wants to help you get licensed to allow you to conduct work legally. It's not difficult to get the license. We can help you. Go to lacontractor.org for more information. Licensed contractors, it's the law.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
A phenomenal day for LSU football. Myles Brennan back in the fold. They've solved their quarterback issue. Miles Frazier, the big offensive lineman from FIU, he picked LSU today. So that's now 14 members of this class. The 13 they signed on Wednesday, Myles Frazier will enroll at LSU. He'll be the 14th member of this class. So 11 spots still to go, and they'll just keep on stacking more talent, more bodies, more holes to fill on this roster. So a fantastic day for LSU. Of course, there was a little bit of a downer that's garnered a lot of attention, which we have not talked about yet. And that is that Elias Ricks is leaving LSU, and not only leaving LSU, he's leaving LSU for Alabama. Okay. This sucks. There's no other way to say it. It really sucks. And I think the reaction from LSU fans is not only that he's leaving, but it's where he's going. I mean, the tweet was, done deal, let's work, roll tide. Full disclosure, I did speak to Eli Ricks' mother, Shauna, yesterday. Just name a full disclosure. And she called me because back in October when Elias chose to have the shoulder surgery, she called then and went on the record, if you recall. It's very different when you have an anonymous source as to the young man's mother speaking on the record. And she called me and said, this is not an opt-out. He's not transferring. It was after Kentucky. It was a shoulder injury that he had in high school, re-aggravated in 2020 during his freshman year. It kept him out of spring football last spring when a lot of rumors started circulating. And then it worsened, and they felt it got to the point where it affected his play. And that's why they chose to shut it down and have the surgery. And she was very adamant that it wasn't an opt-out, it wasn't a transfer. And then ultimately, he did transfer. So she called me to say, listen, when we spoke in October, Ed Ogeron had not been fired at that point, and there was no thought at that point of transferring, and clearly now that has changed. And Elias Ricks did on his Twitter also post a note that was, he wrote, just a personal thank you to Coach O, Coach Raymond, and all the LSU staff that helped me during my process at LSU. I'm grateful for the opportunity and will not forget all the things that were done for me in my time there. Lastly, thank the man above for letting me be where I am today. So I appreciate the honesty, the openness. She didn't have to call me, but it did look bad. I mean, not when you go on the record and say you're not transferring, then you are. It does look bad. But what she told me was that also they were seeking stability, and a part of that makes sense. I'm not. Bear with me because I don't want you to roll your eyes because I am going to get to a deeper point here. I'm just conveying the conversation that we had, that they were seeking stability, which they didn't have in 2 years here, which is very true. If you can objectively take off the purple and gold glasses, zoom out to the 10,000 foot view, you can understand what it was like the last 2 years. It's the same thing that we're talking about why Max Johnson left. You look and go, why would a starter leave? Why would any starter leave any program? I mean, they have their own individual reasons to do so. Whether you agree with it, disagree, whatever, the point is you or I would be looking at it subjectively as a fan who wants what's best for your program, not the individual person, whereas this person is doing what's best for himself. And LSU has been a dumpster fire the last 2 years, from COVID to the racial injustice stuff last summer to firing Bo Pelini to a second defensive coordinator in as many years to now Corey Raymond leaving and Ed Ogeron being fired halfway through the season and opt-outs, and you get it. I mean, you all know what it's been like around here the past 2 years, so much so that LSU paid a man $17 million to go away forever. That's how bad it's been. And wanted to find stability. Is there any more stable program in college football than Alabama? It sucks that he's leaving LSU to go to Alabama and you have to play him. If he left LSU and went to USC or Ohio State, I don't think many people here would really deeply care. But because he's going to Alabama, it stings that much more. I believe that's part of the decision to go to Alabama. That's, let me underscore, part of the decision to go to Alabama. Another part of this is money. I will say this as bluntly as I can say it. Elias Ricks wanted NIL deals. Why wouldn't he? He's a five-star, number one corner in the country, freshman All-American, and he had none here. He had no NIL deals. Derek Stingley got a lot of them. I think there was resentment there because of that. And he gonna get money at Alabama. Guaranteed. Yeah, I mean, we all know, like, you're seeing stories, NIL stories pop up now. The $150K per lineman for the University of Texas. There's other stories that aren't out there that when you actually have the conversations about what's happening in recruiting and underground with NIL, I mean, there are coaches that are given an NIL budget with which to go recruit. I'm not going to name names because I'm not going to be irresponsible and say that publicly without having any concrete evidence of it formally and outwardly. But suffice to say, it's from people I deem really credible, like coaches who have told me this. Yeah. I mean, look at Miami, where there was an NIL deal for the entire roster. I mentioned Jacoby Matthews, y'all. Jacoby Matthews is a guy that LSU desperately wants to get in this class from Ponchatoula. He was committed to LSU. He goes to an elite camp with other five stars, comes back, decommits from LSU, and now is considering A&M in Alabama. Why do you think that is? They weren't on his initial list of finalists. How did A&M and Bama all of a sudden pop up? Well, Tex Aggs is paying dudes money to go do interviews. Bama's got NIL deals. I mean, you go to a game at Kyle Field, there's 20 billionaires in the suites at Kyle Field. They got more money than God, y'all. They can pay whoever they want, however they want. But they're organized enough to do it within the confines of the rules. And that's the bigger issue here. Like, for me, y'all know this is going to upset some of y'all, specifically with Elias Ricks, my feelings, because some of y'all are just, like, foaming at the mouth on it. Elias Ricks from California, he don't care about LSU. You know, he didn't grow up loving LSU, don't care about LSU. Not the way that you or I do. I grew up, born in New Orleans, spent most of my life in Baton Rouge. Even when we lived in New Orleans, I was a kid, on Saturdays, wake up, Dad would drive us up here to the game. We go tailgate on the old front nine. We go to the game, sit in the northeast corner of the end zone. I mean, I was a six-year-old kid in that driving storm against Miami in 88. I mean, like, I've been through it all. You've been through it. We've all got our stories, right? He don't have them. Kids from California. LSU won a natty. He was coming to play for Corey Raymond. They recruited him hard. DBU, Patrick Peterson, all the way through. I mean, Tyrann Mathieu, that's what he saw. There's no loyalty to LSU, and I don't blame him. And some of y'all are going, oh, well, you got to just recruit kids from Louisiana. You know what? That's how LSU ended up going 45 years without winning a national championship. It's not to say you can't win with kids from Louisiana. Of course, there's amazing talent here in Louisiana. But you got to be able to spread your wings and go get a five-star kid out of California or Patrick Peterson out of Florida or Joe Burrow out of Ohio, whatever it is. You know what I mean? Like, you got to be able to get that. You got to be able to do that. So I'm not against going to get these guys nationally. But you got to understand it's a two-way street. You're going to lose guys like Elias Ricks, like you just did. You're going to get guys like Joe Burrow sometimes. You're going to get Miles Frazier out of FIU. Like, this current world of college football is a two-way street. Yes, you're going to lose people, and that's going to suck. But you're going to gain guys as well. You're going to get Major Burns from Georgia to come home. When you need Major Burns from Georgia, I think it's a Major Gaines. Major Burns from Georgia, when you need a safety. You're going to get Mike Jones from Clemson. You're going to get Cole Tracy or Joe Burrow. Like, you're going to get it to work in your favor as well if you're using it properly. So you got to understand you're going to lose guys, but you're going to gain guys as well. And I'm not mad about this. Like, I'm pro student athlete. It sucks. That's a gut punch. There's no doubt about it. And you're better with Elias Ricks. Don't try to convince yourself you're not. Dude's a long 6'2 corner who led your team in interceptions as a true freshman All-America. You are better with that dude. Make no mistake. And it sucks that he's going to Alabama. But I'm not mad at him for it. LSU's been a dumpster fire. He doesn't even know who his defensive coordinator is going to be. And go to Alabama, probably win a title. He just saw Jameson Williams do it. Left Ohio State, goes to Alabama, leads them in receiving. He's going to be a first-round draft pick. It makes sense logically. The part that doesn't make sense for you or me is you're an LSU fan. Elias Ricks isn't. As much as that sucks, that's the hard reality. You just got to make that street work both ways. And I'm going to tell you one thing I loved last night. Dwight McLaughlin, who I think is as talented a corner as there is in college football and is going to be a total baller next year. Dwight McLaughlin quote tweeted Elias Ricks' done deal, let's work, roll tide tweet with another tweet that said, Dwight McLaughlin said, we could have been superstars, with a crying emoji. A short time after that, LaTerrence Welsh from Acadiana, again, a Louisiana guy who does love LSU and wants to play for LSU, quote tweeted McLaughlin and said, let's be superstars. Basically saying, forget about him. He's gone. Let's you and me do it. I love that idea. I love that attitude. I love that mentality. You need dudes like that. And you got them in LaTerrence Welsh. Let's see how quickly he can come along, how quickly Brian Kelly can finish this roster. You're going to do it without Elias Ricks. And you're going to have to see him next year. You can see him next year in Baton Rouge. One out, get one in. It's the way it's going to roll. You can bemoan it. You can cry about the changing landscape of college football, how the fabric of the sport's being ruined. It's always been ruined, y'all. Kids have been getting paid forever. It's just happening above the table now. It's the only difference. The only difference. It's a billion-dollar business that was built on the backs of free labor, and the free labor is now saying, I ain't doing this for free no more. Okay. You made the bed, sleep in it. Make it work both ways. That's the challenge for Brian Kelly. It's a challenge for every coach in college football now. You're going to lose guys. Make sure you gain them as well. All right, Zapped further review. We're not going to break Muso. We'll have Tigers and the Pros to wrap up hour number two next.
AFR.
AFR is brought to you by Insurance Network of Louisiana. They're there for 15 more minutes. 15 more minutes if you want to give them a call right now. 293-0450, 293-0450, 293-0450, or lainsurance.net. I would like to make a very direct plea here. If you have your insurance coverage with Liberty Mutual, I would highly recommend you call Insurance Network of Louisiana now. 293-0450, 293-0450. Liberty Mutual is like the chief offender. There's a lot of them that are bad, but they're the one that gets you in really cheap. They jack rates doing the auto draft. You never realize it happens before you know you're blink, you're overpaying, you forget about it. Call Insurance Network of Louisiana. Typically, people at Liberty Mutual have good coverage. You're just way overpaying. See if you can save some money, get better coverage for less money. 293-0450. Insurance Network of Louisiana independently shops to get you better coverage for less money. 293-0450, 293-0450, or lainsurance.net.
I had to pack up all my things. I had to leave my home. And I never knew where I was going next. It felt like I never even had a say. But then you came along.
Change a child's story. There's a child in foster care waiting for a volunteer like you.
There it is, the extra mile. On the border of expected and extraordinary. For those willing to go further. Like vans customized for work or play. With safety and tech to keep you connected. Supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team. And backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
And our topic today is about savings. What is savings?
Hancock Whitney isn't just a bank for our clients. We're investing in our hometowns, making life better for everyone. So keep dreaming. We've got your back.
Yo, Jake here from Patient Plus Urgent Care Clinic. The place is going to be convenient for you during that inconvenient time, and it's even more convenient now. Now you have 8 convenient locations with the Brule location just opening up. So go check them out online, patientplusuc.com, because remember, they are your place for your sniffles, for your colds, for your stitches, for your COVID tests. They have all that available over at Patient Plus. For more information, visit them at patientplusuc.com. Get in and get better.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 752644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
During these challenging times, we know your healthcare needs don't stop. Cancer, accidents, injuries, and heart disease are relentless. So we are relentlessly innovating to keep you safe, both virtually and in person, connecting you with providers remotely, advancing clinical spaces, providing rapid and accurate testing, social distancing, and certified cleaning protocols. We are Ochsner, and we will not slow down. Ochsner Health, innovating healthcare.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com. ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
Quick reminder about the Williamson Eye Center, williamsoneye.com, 924-2020, 924-2020. If you want to see 2020, call 924-2020. Dr. Blake Williamson and the gang over there at the Williamson Eye Center with locations all over the greater Baton Rouge area, including their brand new location on Bluebonnet, right on the Baton Rouge Generals campus. It's amazing with a state-of-the-art dry eye center, their surgery center. Give yourself or someone you love the gift of sight. If you want to ditch the contacts and glasses forever, they have a way at the Williamson Eye Center. 924-2020 or williamsoneye.com. Okay, Musso, Tigers in the Pro.
Tigers in the Pros. They still bleed purple and gold. They're just really rich now. Presented by Lee Michaels Fine Jewelry. Lee Michaels Fine Jewelry, where Baton Rouge gets engaged.
Milwaukee Bucks, a winner last night over the Indiana Pacers, 114-99. Javonte Smart for the defending champs. 13 minutes, 2 of 2 shooting, 1 of 1 from behind the arc, a 5-point night. Added a rebound in the game. Javonte getting some run with the big club after signing that two-way deal with the Milwaukee Bucks. New Orleans Pelicans, a winner last night, 113-110 over the Oklahoma City Thunder. Of course, the buzzer beater by Devontae Graham. But this is about Garrett Temple and a perfect shooting night for the former Tiger in 16 minutes. 3 of 3, 2 of 2 from behind the arc, 8 points your total, 2 rebounds, and 1 steal for Garrett Temple. Nas Reed and
Lil Nas X.
Lil Nas X?
Well,
like the rapper?
I am trying in earnest. There it is. What's a little low, Muse?
Maybe cue it up. It fades in.
We gotta cue it up to the spot.
It's the effect.
No, we don't have the time for it.
Okay.
So I mean, I'm trying here. We talked about how much more fun this segment is during baseball when we've got Antoine Duplantis and the Cyclones. He's being sent back down.
That's not confirmed.
He's got to be. It's a rule. Dick Goody, I need songs here.
You got songs right now.
I'm trying with Nas. Lil Nas X, do you think?
Lil Nas X.
It could work. Nas,
it
I mean, it's,
work.
It's not.
It's not Nas.
It's Nas.
It's as close as you get.
S or a Z. What do you think?
I kind of like it. Is that a good beat? Like country.
Where's Reggie
good,
Chapman?
It's like he's in Atlanta. It's like country rap. It's like country rap or something. Maybe he is. Anyway, Nas Reed, 12 minutes last night. Tough night though. 1 of 6 shooting. 3 of 4 from the free throw line though. So 6 points, 1 rebound, and a block for Nas, or Nas. We need props. If we're going to do Old Town Road, we need props. So you need to get like a cowboy hat or something you can just pull out from under the desk and put on. The Hudco hat.
The Hudco hat.
A Hudco cowboy hat.
Keep going, Muse.
All right, we'll just leave it going then. All right, Joe Burrow returned to practice in a full capacity today. Of course, had his finger injury. The Bengals will face the Broncos this week. And then Leonard Fournette missed practice again today for the Bucs. He's got an ankle. The Bucs host the Saints. Sunday night football, second day in a row. Leonard Fournette missing practice.
Who was that?
Leonard Fournette.
Who was that?
GameCoinLenny. Hashtag GameCoinLenny.
Hashtag GameCoinLenny.
That's Tigers and the Pros.
Presented by GameCoinLenny.
And?
Lil Nas X.
I mean, and Lee Michaels. The fine jewelers.
I like it. I think we found one.
I kind of like it.
I kind of think we found one, didn't we? Lee Michaels Fine Jewelry, LMFJ.com. Gentlemen, Lee Michaels has been serving the state of Louisiana for 40 years. It's incredible because they've grown, and you think about this logically, it makes a lot of sense. They buy diamonds for 9 different stores. So they buy the best quality diamonds in the world out of India for 9 different stores. So they're buying in bulk, so they get great price that they can pass on to you. So they have a great selection and a great price, all with the personalized service that you get of a hometown jeweler that's been in business for 40 years. Have the Lee Michaels experience, no matter your budget. LMFJ.com. Lee Michaels Fine Jewelry. LMFJ.com. Okay. I am so excited. The one thing we haven't really done a deep dive into is Miles Frazier yet today. The offensive lineman out of FIU who has committed to the Tigers. We'll do that coming up right after the top of the hour. Mike Triplett in 20 minutes. Don't you move. It's AFR.
AFR.
Hudco Roofing. HudcoRoofing.com. I understand it's the holidays, and for many people, you're thinking, I'll just put the roofing thing off until after the holidays. I actually had a call today from someone who said, hey, man, got a family member in Metairie, tried to go with an out-of-town roofer from Florida. Here we are, 4 months post-Ida, still no movement. Can you help? Yes. Yes. Trust a local company that was here before the storm. We'll be here after the storm. That's us, Hudco Roofing. Go to the website, hudcoroofing.com. That's where you need to start, hudcoroofing.com. Hit the Contact Us Now tab right there in the center of the homepage. Fill out a little bit of info. Boom, you're in our system. We'll be in touch. If you are having trouble with your insurance company, we can work with your insurance company to get your claim approved. We can supplement that claim if need be. Or if you have your paperwork, pick a shingle color. We're roofing. Let's roll. HudcoRoofing.com. Do business with someone you know. HudcoRoofing.com.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Follow us on Twitter at 1045ESPN to cast your vote in the Citizens Bank and Trust poll of the day. Vote daily inside Off the Bench, Hunt and Hill, The Early Line. And after further review, Citizens Bank and Trust brings you the poll of the day via Twitter at 1045ESPN.
Service Mastery Elite create clean, disinfected work environments. As a local business, we take pride in serving the New Orleans and Baton Rouge areas. Our cleaning protocols follow CDC and OSHA standards for healthcare settings, offices, senior living, restaurants, and industrial plants. Contact Service Master Elite to get your operation ready for reopening with germ disinfection cleaning. Service Master Elite, the trusted choice in professional cleaning since 1996.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And now 0% for 60 months on Ford F-150s. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
To the heroes who are working tirelessly to care for our communities, we thank you. We will never forget the countless hours you dedicated on the front lines, choosing to risk your own health to fight for our friends, neighbors, and family members.
I mean, you guys are out on the front lines fighting it.
We are grateful for your heroic acts and unwavering spirit. Together, we are overcoming this adversity and make our state healthier and more vibrant again. Ochsner Health.
It's no secret. The best oysters in Baton Rouge are at Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar. Enjoy mouth-watering South Louisiana flavor and oysters from all over the country. And don't forget our nightly drink specials. Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar, located in downtown Baton Rouge.
If you're in a
an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
This is SportsCenter.
I'm Doug Brown. The NFL and the Players Association agree to put all 32 teams into more intensive COVID-19 protocols until at least early next week. Browns quarterback Case Keenum tests positive. The team may be without Baker Mayfield and Keenum for Saturday's game against the Raiders. That could make Nick Mullins the starter. Week 15 kicks off tonight with the Chiefs and Chargers in Inglewood. Chiefs defensive lineman Chris Jones is out. He's on the COVID-19 list. Jaguars coach Urban Meyer is now out of a job less than a year after he was hired by team owner Shad Khan. ESPN's Mike DiRocco says this was a necessary move by Khan.
He sort of felt betrayed a little bit by Urban Meyer in that, you know, I bring you here, I hire you, I expect you to turn my franchise around, and you basically do all these things that make me and the organization look bad.
Mike DiRocco on Greeny. Lakers guards Russell Westbrook and Avery Bradley enter the league's health and safety protocols. That's five Lakers players who've entered the protocols in the last 2 days.
We're back on Friday, reacting to Thursday night football as Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City Chiefs try to run their winning streak to 7 games while Justin Herbert looks to pounce all over the Kansas City Chiefs. That's Friday morning on Keyshawn, J. Will, and Max on ESPN Radio.
Matt Moscona.
I'm very important.
After further review.
Say one more time.
After further review with Matt Moscona.
And here we go.
ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria. Live from the Mercedes-Benz of Baton Rouge Studios.
That's right.
Hour three, off we go. Welcome aboard. Glad you're with us, AFR. Presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. I'm Matt.
This is Shaq O'Neal, and I hate Matt.
Paul O'Neal.
They're chanting Paul O'Neal's name.
Muso. And Mr. Toby Tomplay. All right, we're here. Glad you are as well. Get out there and make it a good one. 5 o'clock quitting time. Glad you are driving home with us. Thanks to Leah Vann, who was here last hour. Jerit Roser in hour number one. Both did an awesome job. Mike Triplett in 15 minutes from right now, as he is every Thursday, to talk Saints, Bucks this week, as the Saints try to make it two in a row and get themselves right back in the mix, in the playoff mix in the NFC. Wednesday was a great day for LSU. Talked about it a lot, added 13 players, covered a whole bunch of needs. In a given year, normally if LSU were adding a five-star quarterback, the number one quarterback in the country, five-star offensive tackle, the number one offensive tackle in the country, you get a big defensive lineman out of Baton Rouge you've been courting for 2 years to stay home. You get Emory Jones in the boat. You get a flip from a wide receiver to flip from Miami, an in-state kid. Great day. We've been pumped. But context matters, and I understand it's only 13 prospects, and some guys you wanted, like Shaz Preston, got out of town, and you get it. You know, Jake Johnson signs with Texas A&M, and I understand why there's some apprehension, and there's still work to do. And then we hear the news about Elias Ricks going to Alabama. But I'm still going to focus on not what you lose, but what you gain, because you literally can't sign everybody. And other teams are going to sign good players as well. Are you signing good players that meet needs on your roster? And the answer emphatically for LSU on Wednesday was yes. And that's just the foundation as they build toward the February signing day and transfers. And speaking of that, LSU got some good news on Thursday, today, as Myles Brennan has announced that he is staying at LSU. He is exiting the transfer portal and will finish out his fifth season at LSU. Gave a full reaction to that earlier in the show, but it's the absolute best decision for best possible outcome for LSU. They were going to have to go into the transfer portal anyway to get a quarterback. Why not just get the guy that's been here for 4 years already? Myles Brennan tweeted it earlier today. There's no place like home. Let's ride Tiger Nation, and announcing that he will return to LSU for a fifth season and presumably be the starter. And then after that, you'll let Garrett Nussmeier and Walker Howard, whoever else may be part of this roster, battle it out in 2023 and beyond. But Myles Brennan is returning to LSU. And then even maybe not better news, but more good news came when Miles Frazier, the big offensive lineman out of FIU, who took an official visit to LSU this past weekend, made his decision public. And he, of course, picked LSU. Miles Frazier was a two-star coming out of New Jersey. Played in one game as a freshman at FIU in 2020. Became an All-American in 2021. And had offers from everybody and ultimately landed on LSU. So, this is a massive get at a huge area of need. He had 34 teams pursuing him. 34. When he entered the transfer portal, he was listed in the transfer portal as the second best offensive lineman in the transfer portal rankings. The second best offensive lineman in the transfer portal rankings. You are in a desperate spot right now, a desperate spot for offensive linemen, where you need guys that can contribute immediately, not only just contribute, but be a starter immediately. And just like that, you've added Will Campbell, Emory Jones, Fitzgerald West, Bo Bordelon, who's a little bit of a project player, as we understand, but two guys who could be immediate impact guys in Will Campbell, Emory Jones, and now you go into the portal and get Myles Frazier, who again is listed as the second best offensive lineman in the transfer portal this year, who's committed. Again, a two-star offensive lineman when he was coming out of New Jersey. He had only small school offers. He had offers from FIU, Toledo, Bowling Green, Buffalo, and Central Michigan. I mean, this was not a highly sought-after prospect when he signed. Played in one game as a freshman at FIU in 2020, and then in 2021, this season, he emerges as the starting left tackle, makes 11 starts in 12 games, allowed only 4 sacks, was one of the highest-rated offensive linemen on Pro Football Focus this year, the highest-rated in the transfer portal by Pro Football Focus, and now he's an LSU Tiger. You got him on campus last weekend for an official visit. Brian Kelly and his staff obviously did great work. It has to help having Brad Davis in place. Your offensive line coach, who you know is going to be there, having him in place for that official visitor weekend this past weekend, getting the last bite at the apple before signing day, clearly proved to be significant for LSU, and they address his position of need. So when you look at the offensive line and what it's going to look like for 2022, you know you're losing Austin Deculus, you're losing Ed Ingram, you're losing Liam Shanahan. You're losing 3 of your 4 starters for sure. Those guys are gone. Remains to be seen what Chasen Hines and Cam Wire will do. Both could leave, both could return. We'll wait and see. But for the immediate short term in this conversation, let's assume that they're both going to leave. Or just assume. Right? I don't know that definitively, but for the sake of this exercise, let's assume Cam Wire is not back, okay? You return Anthony Bradford, who you know can play guard or tackle, and they're very high on him. Garrett Dellinger, who was forced into some really tough spots as a true freshman offensive lineman, playing left, right, guard, tackle. Tough spot, held his own, even was in some extra offensive line, like jumbo packages. They're very high on what he can be. Marlon Martinez, Xavier Hill, Marcus Dumervil, Charles Turner, Cardell Thomas, all return next year, assuming there's no transfers among that group, which there could be, but that's seven. And then you're adding Frazier, Campbell, Emory Jones, Fitzgerald West, and Bordelon. That's five, which makes 12 offensive linemen. Your numbers there are good, and you have the possibility of Hines and Wire returning. I'm not sure if they will, but you have the possibility of them returning. They could leave. We'll see. They have a decision to make. All of a sudden, you can piece together an offensive line that looks pretty good. Maybe it's Charles Turner finally in a fourth year developing enough to be a starting center in the SEC. And if you start there, well, now you kind of like how you can build around that. Because you can put Will Campbell and Myles Frazier at either tackle spot. Maybe Frazier's your left and Campbell's your right. And then your guard spots, Bradford and Xavier Hill or Marlon Martinez. I mean, Hill played a lot this year and they liked what he did. You have guys now in your starting line that have played football, that have gotten experience, and you feel are going to get better together as they grow up into those roles. So it's hard to overstate how important it is getting Myles Frazier today. Because you've got a ready-made starter on the offensive line. Not a question mark. A guy that is ready to start right now. And that's just massive. At the most massive position in need. And it also speaks to what this coaching staff is going to do to fill in the needs. Again, as disappointing as it is when you see guys leave the program, it's disappointing to see Max Johnson leave. And it's disappointing to see Elias Ricks leave because you feel like you have a lot invested in those guys and they were here and if they stayed, you'd be even better. But the other side of the transfer equation is true as well. You're going to improve your roster immediately because of the transfer portal. Myles Frazier is a great example of that. Now, go get a running back. Go get a linebacker. Maybe go get a cornerback. See how that builds throughout this offseason. But you're going to hit the transfer portal between now and February. And then after as well, keep in mind, even after spring ball, when spring ball ends, you're going to have guys leave their programs. And you'll gain even more then. So a long way to go to continue building that roster. But two major additions today, getting Myles Brennan back in the fold to solve your quarterback issue with a veteran and adding Myles Frazier as well, who could very well be protecting Myles Brennan's blind side. All right, it's after further review. Speaking of protecting the blind side, both of the New Orleans Saints starting offensive tackles missed practice today. And it looks like they're going to play Tampa without either Ramchek or Teron Armstead. Mike Triplett joins us every Thursday. We'll do that next to preview Saints and Bucks. Stick around.
AFR.
Thursday night football kicks off tonight. You need a place to watch. Get by Pluckers. Nicholson just south of campus. Bluebonnet right in front of the Mall of Louisiana. Dine-in, carry-out, delivery. Uber Eats, DoorDash, Uber Eats, DoorDash, Uber Eats, DoorDash. What a Thursday night football game tonight. How about the AFC West? Chiefs? Chargers from SoFi. I mean, Patrick Mahomes and the Chargers, or the Chiefs have been in fuego. Justin Herbert and the Chargers, one of the best young quarterbacks in the NFL. 9-4 Chiefs, 8-5 Chargers. Get on by Pluckers and watch it. All you can eat boneless buffalo bites tonight and every Thursday at Pluckers. That's a little boneless chicken bites, breaded, fried, tossed in your favorite wing sauce. Eat as many of them as you want all night long at Pluckers. Nicholson, just south of campus. Bluebonnet right in front of the Mall of Louisiana. Full slate of NBA games as well. College basketball, the best place to watch all of it is at Pluckers. Nicholson, Bluebonnet, dine-in carry-out delivery, Pluckers, if you don't like our wings. We'll give you the bird.
Gulf Coast Office Products is a nationally recognized Savin office equipment dealer based right here in Louisiana. Over 100 employees strong, Gulf Coast has the boots on the ground to support all vertical markets from education, engineering, legal, and finance. With the latest in office technology from desktop to production segment units, Gulf Coast and Savin have the perfect fit for you. Call 225-756-2644. That's 756-2644 for Gulf Coast Office Products.
Thank you, Acadiana, for 54 years of allowing Corvell Toyota in Opelousas to take care of you and your automotive needs. Enjoy this holiday season with family and friends. From our family to yours, Merry Christmas and Happy New Year!
You know, our topic today is about savings. What is savings?
Hancock Whitney isn't just a bank for our clients. We're investing in our hometowns, making life better for everyone. So keep dreaming. We've got your back.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Starting in 1974, Central Plumbing has served Baton Rouge and surrounding areas for all of their plumbing needs. Through these tough and trying times, we want you to remember that the Payne family is here to continue to support and serve you. As a multi-generational business, there is no job that is too big or too small. Residential, commercial, industrial, hospitality, we're here for anything you need. 24/7, 365, give us a call, 225-925-8552.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
We're familiar with this team. They're really good. They're a really good team. Certainly good, you know, defense. And look, I got a lot of respect for them and what they've done over the years. And it'll be a good challenge. And you know, I missed the game this year, and I'm excited to be a part of this one.
Taysom Hill meeting with the media before the Saints play the Bucs. He's even got the Sean Payton / Drew Brees look, listen, down. I mean, it's. Would you isolate that? I don't know if you can find it in there, but look, listen. It's Sean Payton says it all the time. Brees did it all the time, and now apparently Taysom is doing it. Did Jameis do it? Mike Triplett could probably answer that question. Mike, thanks for the time. How are you? Help me out there, Muse, please.
I'm doing well. Thanks for having me.
Our pleasure. Did Jameis, in his brief stint as starter, use the look, listen, preface for every answer?
Oh, my goodness. That's a really good... I need to go back. I would say no. I think this. Look, I don't think
Well done, dude. Well done. So good.
But I don't think he got it. Look, Jameis had his own special speaking. What's the word? Like the presence about him was something that actually really stood out about him, and I think everybody believes that. So he did not just fit the same mold. An interview with Jameis felt like a special experience, unique experience, different than the look. Listen, I think this we've heard from so many others.
So good. Okay. I think this, it's impossible to talk about the Saints without starting with the injury report. All right, Ramchick and Armstead both on the injury report as not practicing Wednesday or Thursday. So am I to assume that they will not play this weekend against Tampa?
I can't make that assumption for sure with Teron Armstead because he's been doing this for weeks now where we have seen him in the building in his jersey leaving early
Last week he was limited, at least I think, in a couple of practices before he ended up playing. And this week he hasn't been listed as limited yet, but he has been playing despite barely practicing at times during this injury, but obviously it's not getting better. So I put him as definitely questionable. Ramczyk certainly seems doubtful to me. And I think this injury has lingered longer for Ramczyk than they expected, but we haven't seen him on the practice field at all. So,
Someone who does appear to be back is Chauncey Gardner-Johnson. How big would he be in this game in particular against Tampa?
Oh, really big. You know, it's funny, when he started to come into his own, I don't always do deep dive tape studies, but I did one last summer when the Buccaneers signed Brady, and I was going to, you know, write a little about how the Saints have always defended Bruce Arians' offense and how that might change with Brady. And I went back and watched every snap of how they defended Tampa Bay. And that was, I came away more impressed than ever with Gardner Johnson because of how well he did against Chris Godwin in the slot. And that was the year that Chris Godwin really exploded as one of the best receivers in the NFL. And Gardner Johnson was fantastic against him in the slot. And then since then, I think he's really earned a reputation as being good against a lot of guys in the slot. But that really opened eyes for me from his rookie year. And so I think you saw signs of it then, and I think that's been a big part of why they match up well against the team. Obviously, we know Lattimore matches up well against Evans, and I think Gardner-Johnson matches up well against Godwin, and you go a long way when you do that. Look, Cam Jordan back in practice today from COVID. I think the Saints will have all 11 starters healthy on defense for this game, and no matter what question marks we have about this offense, we know that this defense has been a bit of kryptonite for Tom Brady and the Buccaneers. All the turnovers they forced, they certainly won 38-3 there last year. So I'm very intrigued to see a healthy Saints defense against the Buccaneers offense, which is the best in the NFL this year.
That blowout game was in primetime too, wasn't it, Mike?
Yep.
Yeah.
It was.
And they'll be back on in primetime on Sunday Night Football this week down in Tampa. You wrote earlier this week about Alvin Kamara and his return against the Jets. So this matchup in particular is kind of curious. Kamara didn't have a great game against Tampa the first go-round, in large part because I think we know how good that Bucs front seven is, mm-hmm. and where they are kind of vulnerable is in the second, or have been, is in the secondary. So
yep.
Am I to believe, like, the Saints' bad passing game could actually make some hay against this Bucs secondary, or is the bad-on-bad going to default to Tampa here?
Yeah, it's still bad on that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Unfortunately, we've seen the Saints play good passing defenses, bad passing defenses, everything in between, and none of it has generated a good Saints passing offense. Now, they can take advantage of situations. Look, you know, play action works even against a team that's great against the run. It's not like they don't have to try to stop the run. I like some of these Taysom Hill rollout passes to Nick Bennett.
Mm-hmm.
Taysom Hill showing that he can throw to Alvin Kamara. It's something he's worked on. And I think they had a pretty nice rhythm last week. So, you know, I don't think they air it out and just torch the corners. But they will absolutely take advantage of, you know, I think Taysom Hill's always been very good at executing the play as designed when the play is well designed and getting it to that first or second read. And I think Sean Payton can design some plays that can take advantage of this defense. So I do think that the passing game has to be part of the equation. They threw for, I think they threw for 298 against this team with the combination of Winston and Simeon earlier this year. So there are vulnerabilities there for sure.
So are you saying that they should start Trevor Simeon?
I did not say that.
It sounded like what you said. I mean, that's what I heard from you. That's what I thought I heard.
Yeah, I did not say that. From Simeon to Hill, maybe you would give Simeon a slight advantage in some passing categories. But I think I'm going to go with the one that also has the ability to run for 100 yards. I think that puts Hill over the edge in that battle.
He ain't rushing for 100 yards against Tampa. Let's get real. I mean, Tampa.
No, probably not.
Yeah, that
although, if you saw what Josh Allen did last week, okay. week, having one of the best run defenses in the NFL doesn't automatically mean you can stop a quarterback from running, and we know the Saints fans know that better than anyone because the Saints stop everybody from running except Jalen Hurts.
Touche. I mean, maybe that is the kryptonite, is let Taysom Hill go run it 35 times against Tampa. Maybe this is the thing. Any reason to believe, though, that Kamara will have a bigger day this time around against Tampa than last?
Yeah. Look at Leonard Fournette, too. I mean, these two teams are kind of like the Spider-Man. I mean, they stop great running backs. But the beauty of Kamara, obviously, is he can do so many different things. He doesn't have to run between the tackles. He can run wide. And if that's not working, you can pass it to him. And if checkdown passes aren't working, you can line him up as a receiver or line him up in the slot. So Kamara can do so many different things that the fact that he is 92% of this offense, I have a feeling they will find ways to have some success with Alvin Kamara in this game.
Dude, and they actually made kicks last week. It's incredible. And was it just a moment in time,
yeah,
or did Brett Maher coming into his
like
own?
You're getting a little. This is the most optimistic conversation. One win, and all of a sudden you turn into the rose-colored glasses guy.
That's not fair. No, that's not fair, okay? But I also blame you because it was you, Mike Triplett, who, while I was sitting at the Sazerac house a few hours before the Saints played Dallas, you convinced me.
I give you hope.
Convinced me why it wasn't absurd to think if they won that game against Dallas, 10 days off, you play the Jets, you're going to get people healthy. You look at the schedule with Miami and Atlanta and Carolina. Like, you could do it. I'm like, you know what? I'll be damned. That's actually really quite logical.
Right.
And you gave me hope, Triplett, and they lost.
I'll give you more in this holiday season. All those things are true. All those things are true if they sneak this one out. They beat Tampa Bay all of a sudden. Everyone's like, Saints, they're going to the playoffs.
Mm.
It's the if they beat Tampa Bay part that's the hard part.
Yeah.
That's the part I think you must have been sipping during that part. You didn't hear that part. If they beat the team that they're double-digit underdogs for the first time ever in the Sean Payton era.
Ooh, that's a good little
double-digit underdog.
Good nugget there. I was not sipping. I don't drink on air. I wait until after. And then I basically drank the whole game because that Dallas game was brutal to watch. And besides, that was at home in primetime against Dallas, who's kind of meh. This is on the road against Tampa, who's you know what I mean?
Yeah, and Tampa has been startlingly good at home this year. And their home road differential is, you know, I mean, obviously the Tampa that the Saints beat twice last year, they got their act together later in the year. They've been a lot better since then. But, I mean, look, three out of the last four games since Tom Brady arrived there, the Saints performed really well against them. So there is something about this matchup that brings out the best in them. I did not pick the Saints to win. But, you know, I like watching the Saints defense against the Buccaneers offense. It's been Tom Brady's biggest challenge almost since he got to Tampa.
Yeah, that's very fair. I want to ask kind of the big picture tanking question, but I feel like I'm going to ask you that every week that we talk.
Mm.
I know they're not going to tank, right? Like, they're not going to try to lose. But do you think some of the personnel decisions as far as bringing guys back from injury could be influenced by that?
I think they could be at a certain point, but I think we're talking mathematical elimination or you know, 1 in 100 chance. And they're nowhere near that yet. Like I said, part of the reason I gave you hope before is I think they're, depending on how they look in this game, I think they'll be favored in each of their last three games.
Oh, I agree.
You know, they're going to be mathematically alive for the playoffs with a reasonable chance to believe they could get in, even if they lose to Tampa. Now, if they lose to Tampa and Miami, then maybe you're like, all right, let's not bring Ramchek back this year at this point. You know, maybe you have those discussions if they lose the next two, but we're nowhere close to that yet.
Hmm. Are they going to get Aaron Rodgers?
I don't think so for a couple of reasons. I do think the Saints will consider all grand possibilities at that position, though. I don't think they have it in their DNA to be like, no, we're rebuilding. We're going to take a conservative, long-term rebuilding approach. They will take swings, and those swings could include Aaron Rodgers or Russell Wilson. But I think the problem is, I think the New York Giants, who have two top 10 picks, will want Aaron Rodgers and Russell Wilson. I think that you know, the Denver Broncos, who might have a, you know, a higher draft pick, will want Aaron Rodgers, and Rodgers wants to go there. I think, you know, the Jets have two top 10 picks. The Dolphins might have two high, you know, all these teams that have more ammo than the Saints. Even if the Saints want Wilson and Wilson wants him, it'd be hard for them to make the best offer for Wilson or Rodgers.
Hmm. But Russell Wilson has no trade clause, and he would accept the trade to New Orleans.
I'm the one giving hope. I'll never say never on it. You know, the Saints are a team that will look to take big swings like that. And the salary cap, sure enough, Nick Underhill and I both did the same exercise. It's like, all right, there's $70 million over the cap for next year. All right, let me pull open the spreadsheet. How hard is this going to be? All right, let me do my first run through. If I convert all these bonuses, oh, $98 million. Perfect. I've gotten $28 million under now. Easy. Didn't have to cut anybody.
Okay.
So it's always easier than it looks now. You know, you just don't want it to drop by another $35 million unexpectedly because of a pandemic. But they can find ways if that's the route they want to go. And I would never say never for aggressive moves like that.
I always appreciate your time. You're very kind and very thoughtful, and we do appreciate you making time to be with us on these Thursdays. And if you're so kind, we'll do it again next week.
All right. Thanks for having me.
Thanks, Mike. We appreciate you. That is Mike Triplett. This is After Further Review. Look, we appreciate having Mike. Listen, I think he's really good at what he does. What I think is... I think Mike.
He's a quick study.
I think Mike is a quick study. I think he's got some ability.
He's long, athletic, versatile. We like the player.
We like the player a lot. We like the writer. Good penmanship. We like him. We like him a lot. Yeah, he's good. It's After Further Review, brought to you by GMFS Mortgage, GMFSMortgage.com. Changing lives since 1999. Home buy, refi, construction loans, you know the drill, GMFSMortgage.com. Oh, that's what I got to remind you, is that now, through Christmas, every week during December, our friends at GMFS Mortgage are helping great local businesses through their Go Local initiative. Go to the website, GMFSMortgage.com, right there on the homepage. You'll see the Go Local flipper. And it'll explain to you how you can win your share of $5,000 worth of gift cards to great local businesses that are participating in the Go Local event. $1,000 per week in gift cards during the month of December. Go check it out at GMFSMortgage.com. GMFSMortgage.com. GMFS Mortgage. Changing lives. Okay. We'll grab a break. We got Jimmy Ott coming up in about 15 minutes. Otter Locks. We get Otter's thoughts on Thursday Night Football tonight. A really good one with the Chiefs and the Chargers. When we come back, though, let's just take some time. I want to recap the last 2 days, where the roster is, what it's looking like, both short and long term. And also haven't talked yet about Trey Palmer, who has entered the transfer portal. I'll give you a thought on that as well. So stay with us here. It's AFR.
AFR.
If you're thinking about selling your home, do it now. Call Darren James. You might be thinking, I'll wait till the spring. Don't wait till the spring when the market gets saturated. Do it right now. New year in a new home. And if you need to sell your home, call the realtor that sells more homes than anyone. Call Darren James. 335-7666. 335-7666. 335-7666. That's Darren. So you can text him right now and say, hi, Darren. I heard Matt talking about you. 335-7666 or agent225.com. The realtor that spends more money marketing his listings than any other realtor. The realtor that works harder to get your home sold faster. Sells more homes than anyone. The realtor with the Love It or Leave It program. Have to move out of your home within a year. He'll sell it for free for his half of the commission. It's Darren James. 335-7666. 335-7666 or agent225.com.
Think real estate. Think Darren James.
This holiday season, headed to Edwin Watts.
If you're in an accident, a car accident, a slip and fall where you're injured, you need to call an attorney. The defendant insurance company, it's their goal to close the case as quickly as possible and pay out the least amount of money as possible. That's why it's important to call an attorney and call the law offices of O.C. Brown.
At the law office of O.C. Brown, we're a family-owned firm. We want to be your law firm for a lifetime.
Gulf Coast Bank and Trust is giving our customers the power to bank anywhere, anytime during this challenging event. And we're right there with you. Our mobile banking app is a smart way to manage your money and time. Gulf Coast Bank and Trust, the bank that cares about you.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And now 0% for 60 months on Ford F-150s. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
This is a house call. This is a follow-up appointment. This is a diabetes checkup. This isn't just more convenient care. It's more advanced care. This is innovating healthcare at Louisiana's number one hospital, Ochsner.
Front to Back Boat Service has been family owned and operated for 30 years. And the Sherman family is NMEA certified. That's the National Marine Electronics Association at Front to Back. They are committed to improving the safety and technology of marine electronics through installer training, interface standards. And look, the fall and the winter, it's the perfect time to do that yearly maintenance you've been putting off. Get those parts you've been wanting. So schedule your appointment today at Front to Back North Airway off of Airline Highway.
Eli's always been into grilling. It took us a while to see it, but the signs were there.
What are you doing, Eli?
I knew grilling was my thing. I have been talking about it throughout my career.
Happy with the results?
I am. Got the new grill from barbecueguys.com. It performed great.
My advice, as I always told my boys,
do more of what you're born to do.
Barbecue Guys, for those who were born to grill.
You want cheese on your burger, Pops?
I'll take a little cheese.
Tonight, we invite you to celebrate life, wherever and whenever you can. Understanding that time is never on our side. Instead, gather up your friends tonight and share a few stories and laughs over a good bottle of wine. Or maybe a family meal that gives everyone a chance to reconnect and remember what's really important, whether it's for a birthday, an anniversary, or simply to remind someone special.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
All right, rolling along, quick segment here before we get to Otter Locks. Glad you're hanging out. Remember, we're brought to you by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Blue Bond and Baton Rouge, Ambassador Caffrey and Lafayette online, theantiagingclinics.com. All this month, spend $100 in gift cards, get $50 free at the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. So, we did find out today that LSU has had another player enter the transfer portal. I've told you this for weeks and weeks and weeks. There are players that are going to opt out of the bowl game. There are more players that are going to transfer. And there are going to be players that are academically ineligible for this bowl game. It's going to happen. You might be mad at me for saying it. I don't care. I'm telling you, Trey Palmer's not the last player that's going to transfer out. There will be guys that opt out of the bowl game. And you're going to have players that are academically ineligible. Like, they're going to be thin for this bowl game. But Palmer is an interesting one. After three seasons in Baton Rouge, he's not going to play in the Texas Bowl. He's entered the transfer portal. He's the third receiver to enter the transfer portal. Coy Moore did it earlier this year. Deion Smith last week. And now Trey Palmer becomes the third. As long as Kayshon Boutte is back, I'm good. He's a tilt-the-field guy. And it sounds like he's going to be back. And as long as he is, that's a foundational piece for your offense. Just look, he got injured against Kentucky. Just look at what LSU's offense did post-Kentucky. They ran the ball like wild against Florida, but then they scored 17, 14, 13 in consecutive weeks. They scored 27 against ULM. Let me say that again. They scored 27 against ULM. Like, you got to have Kayshon Boutte out there. as long as he's there, I like everything else that falls into place. Nine receivers on the roster. Kirkland, Boutte, Alex Adams, Jerit Jenkins, Devontae Lee, Malik Nabers, Jack Besh, Brian Thomas, Chris Hilton, and they, of course, signed Landon Ibieta on Wednesday. Obviously, some of those guys are upperclassmen that may well have their careers end after this season. They could choose to go pro. We'll see Jerit Jenkins and Devontae Lee, what happens there. Palmer played in 28 games in 3 years in Baton Rouge. He was effective. I mean, he was effective as a receiver. He was effective as a returner, but never quite established himself as a key member of the rotation. Last year got passed up by Kayshon Boutte, as everybody did, and then this year got passed up by Malik Nabers and Jack Besh and Brian Thomas. It just kind of the nature of how it went for Palmer. He was in the rotation, but not at the top of the rotation at LSU. As a matter of fact, his greatest moment as a Tiger is probably the historic moment he had last year against South Carolina.
On the dead run, fumbling the ball is Trey Palmer. Picks it up. Now he's got no momentum. Still finds a crease. Trey Palmer gets loose. Turns the corner. Gets to midfield. Can any Gamecock have an angle to bring him down before the end zone? They cannot. Touchdown.
That was Trey Palmer's kickoff return for a touchdown against South Carolina. As we all know, as friends and fans of Richard Condon, as he made that his mantra for years, he wanted to see an LSU player return a kickoff for a touchdown in Tiger Stadium, which had not happened since Eric Martin did it against Kentucky way back in 1981, and Condon got to see it before he died, and it was Trey Palmer, and for that, I guess we'll always be grateful, mostly so Condon can shut up and stop talking about the Eric Martin kickoff return back in 1981. But it was Trey Palmer who did that, and at times he was an electric player, but I also understand it where you want the ball. And he should leave and go somewhere where he's going to be a dynamic number one receiver. Go to Texas Tech. Go to Louisiana Tech and play under Sonny Cumbie and catch 80 balls next year and go pro. I look at the way that this receiver rotation went, and it was just so obvious where Kayshon Boutte was your number one, and then you kind of see how the rest of it all emerged. Malik Nabers, very clearly by the end of the year, was your number two. Jack Besh became your second leading receiver behind Kayshon Boutte, which that in and of itself speaks volumes about Boutte. He only played six games and still finished the season your leader in receiving yards and receiving touchdowns. You understand how good he is. We all do. But next year going into the season, Boutte, Malik Nabers, Jack Besh, whatever order you want to have those. And then Brian Thomas Jr., who had some really nice moments this year, did have a few drops, but got on the field early, and they loved him in fall camp. He's the big-bodied, big-target wide receiver. And then let's see if Chris Hilton can maybe emerge. You know, he's a big five-star guy from Zachary who everyone was very excited about, has the speed and the athleticism, needs to maybe develop into the position, but they've got guys there. They have receivers. They have strong, fast, athletic guys that can run and jump and catch the ball and make you miss, and I just don't worry about LSU there. Yeah, you'd love it for everybody to be able to pan out, but it's one of those positions where, like offensive line, you got to sign a bunch of them and hope that you hit in the way the rotation works and plan for attrition. So you wish Trey Palmer the best wherever he goes. I mean, he was the number 112 overall recruit in the country when he signed with LSU back in 2019. Part of the championship team as a freshman, and now is heading elsewhere to finish off his college career. So we wish Trey Palmer the best in whatever is next for him. All right, so after further review, we're brought to you by Shawbills Tire and Auto Service, shawbillstire.com, 18 locations in South Louisiana. If you're going over the hills through the woods to grandmother's house this Christmas, before you do, make sure you bring your vehicle to Shawbills. I tell you every day, bumper-to-bumper auto service and name-brand tires at wholesale prices. So if your brakes are squeaking, take it to Shawbills. Need a tire your tires rotated, take them to Shawbills. Need your oil changed, go to Shawbills. Check engine lights on, take it to Shawbills. Bumper-to-bumper auto service and name brand tires at wholesale prices. They'll sell you the best tires on the road for the cheapest price possible. That's Shawbills. Shawbillstire.com. Shawbills, where we keep you rolling. All right, we got one thing left to do. Jimmy Ott will be here for Otter Locks. Thursday night football tonight. Chiefs, Chargers. It'll be a good one. Looking forward to this game tonight. We'll get a pick from the Otter on that, see if there's anything on the college or NBA slate that he likes as well. Bowl season gets started tomorrow. We'll see if Jimmy maybe has some early bowl picks. And, of course, it is Thursday, which means Kalucci! Get your Kalucci pick as well. Stick around. We'll wrap up a Thursday AFR next.
AFR.
Okay, we are inching closer to January. I've been telling you about the Baton Rouge General Healthy Men Project, brgeneral.org/healthymen, brgeneral.org/healthymen. The Healthy Men Project, designed to help men set health goals, hold them accountable to achieve them. So many times, men, especially age 30 to 50, and I'm in that demographic, we ignore health. We ignore symptoms. We ignore warning signs. We don't go for physicals. We don't go for checkups. We, as it, on the website, it says, drink more water and less alcohol. Well, that sucks, but it's something when you get older, you got to think about doing. So the Healthy Men Project is designed to help you set these health and fitness goals and attain them. And they have great prizes as well. It's totally free to sign up. Go to brgeneral.org/healthymen. brgeneral.org/healthymen to learn more. brgeneral.org/healthymen.
Custom color. You know, our topic today is about savings. What is savings?
Hancock Whitney isn't just a bank for our clients. We're investing in our hometowns, making life better for everyone. So keep dreaming. We've got your back.
If home is where the heart is, a roof is a shield. That's why for over 25 years, South Louisiana always turns to Garcia Roofing and Sheet Metal. For more information, visit GarciaDidMyRoof.com.
At All-Star Toyota, you get it all. If you're in the market for an all-new Toyota vehicle, come see our friendly and knowledgeable sales team at All-Star Toyota. Located in Baton Rouge at the corner of Airline and Goodwood, we've been serving our community since 2005 by offering a large selection of new Toyota cars, trucks, and SUVs. Get behind the wheel of your dream car and take a test drive at All-Star Toyota today.
Yo, Jake here from Patient Plus Urgent Care Clinic, reminding you they now have 8 convenient locations across the Baton Rouge area, open from 9 a.m. until 9 p.m. And if you're looking for that COVID test for holiday travel, or you have a holiday event coming up, they are the place for you, as well as a flu shot starting to creep up here during flu season. So if you need that shot, make sure you get that. They now have some available through December. You can find more information on their website, patientplusuc.com. That's Patient Plus Urgent Care Clinic. Get in and get better.
I've been doing business with Luba for 25 years. They're dependable, trustworthy. It's just the attention to detail with our clients.
Our folks have years and years of experience. They're highly trained professionals. But many companies have that asset. What I'd like to think makes Luba a bit different is that we use those talents in a way that truly is dedicated to serving the needs of the folks who depend on us.
There it is, the extra mile, on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded, because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
This isn't just another day. It's so much more. Kelly's life was put on hold when her Ochsner primary care doctor discovered a rare blood disorder. Her doctor connected her to an Ochsner care team of cancer, heart, and kidney specialists. With multiple primary care locations around Baton Rouge, same-day appointments, and online scheduling, we're relentless about keeping you healthy. Ochsner Baton Rouge, innovating healthcare.
After further review with Matt Moscona, presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, Baton Rouge, Lafayette, and online at theantiagingclinics.com, ESPN Baton Rouge, New Orleans, Alexandria.
Down the stretch we come, wrapping up a Thursday edition of AFR presented by the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana. Got to remind you about our friends at MyCleanLiving.net, NASA technology inside of their air purifiers. Clinically proven to eliminate the virus that causes COVID-19 and dozens of other pathogens. Y'all, it ain't just COVID. Flu's going around right now, cold, strep. Protect the air and spaces that you and your family and your coworkers are in. MyCleanLiving.net. If you've got questions, the phone number right there at the top. the local rep. Jennifer can answer your questions. 413-2299, 413-2299. MyCleanLiving.net, MyCleanLiving.net. You can order right on the website. You don't have to talk to anybody. You can just order on the website, have it delivered to your door, and you never have to have a personal conversation. Go to MyCleanLiving.net to learn more. All right, let's find out what we're betting on tonight. Time for Otter Locks.
Otter Locks, presented by Clark Crane Chrysler Dodge Jeep Ram in St. Francisville. Because a great deal is worth a short drive to Clark Crane.
So we turn to the one and only, the incomparable and of an incomprehensible, the Otfather himself, Jimmy Ott. Otter, what's up?
Hello, Jay!
That's so good. All right, give me a winner. Give me a winner. Give me a winner.
Well, hey, you want to get the Colucci picks or my picks?
I said give me a winner. Give me Colucci's picks. What are you talking about? Give me a winner, Otter. Give me Colucci.
Now, look, at one point in the second quarter when it was 45-16, Cavs, I said, this might be a rocket game for us tonight. So, let's get to the Colucci man right now where his mother puts Italian cheeses and sausages and stuff.
What happened to your
phone? Jimmy, it's beautiful.
Got it.
Your
phone was doing the Charlie Brown's teacher thing again, but it's better now.
Oh, geez, Charlie Brown's teacher and Colucci. My goodness, I mean, that's a combination. You know what? It may have just been my accent anyway, Bruins and Islanders.
All right.
Boston, gone to the island, baby. All right, Long Island. Bruins at 14-11. Islanders at 7-17. But Colucci likes the Islanders in this one. It's gone from 109 to 128. Don't know what's up. I don't know if the Bruins have COVID. I just take the picks and I pass them along.
I love it.
They play on ice. I know that the machine that cleans the ice in between the periods is Zamboni, and that's about it. Islanders, minus $1.28 is your first one. And then we're going to Nashville. I think it's the Goodyear Arena. Is that right?
It's Bridgestone Arena.
Bridgestone, yes, the tire.
It was a tire. You were close.
Yeah, Michelin, you know, who's keeping track? Predators 17-11, Avalanche 17-9, basically identical record. Avalanche, a big favorite here. It opened up 35. It's up to $1.77. Colucci is going with the dog. He's going with the dog for the Predators. So that's his two picks on the early games. He'll be with us at 6:30 for some more picks later on. But early action on the ice, Nashville Predators and the New York Islanders.
Money line, correct, on both?
Yes.
Money
yes.
line on both. Okay.
Unless specified. Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
So you got any basketball? Thursday night football tonight. Yeah, what you like? I've been teasing that all day.
Oh, you thought last night's basketball schedule was bad in college hoops. You should see tonight.
Yeah.
Roto-Rooter. Come on in, Chucky. Clean this up. But anyway, look, man, six in a row, covered six in a row. The public team, Troy Macker, sent me the specs on where the action's going. It's very, very close to moving 3.5. I've seen a 3.5 or two. Most of them have like 3-20. I'm just going to take the Chargers in this one. I mean, Max, is Jones out for this one? He's out. That's the big move that they made from the edge to inside. And their defense is, held people to 17 or less. I'm taking Herbert in the points. What I think is a pick-em type of game. I'm going with the Chargers tonight, +3. And, hey, I'll chalk early dogs late. Wait till about 5-10 minutes before kickoff and hopefully get 3.5.
Okay. Jimmy Ott gave you the Chargers +3. Colucci! Gave you the Islanders and the Predators. Get in on those right now. Yes, Otter.
Yeah, so when I asked him, I said, well, your mom makes oyster dressing with the turkey? He goes, no, Italian cheeses, Italian sausages, all stuffed together. It's beautiful. I'm going to the Colucci house. Like, thank you. DJ, where are we going, Dad? Well, we're going to Colucci.
We're going to Colucci's. He's such a beauty. Where are you tonight?
Jolie Pearl Oyster Bar.
Obviously, yes. Of course, Thursday.
Library. Yes, indeed. So it's kind of a mild night for December, huh?
I know. Well, it sometimes it goes this way, Otter, and then sometimes in March we end up, or early April, we have a cold snap and it's 30 degrees. So, and the old ice box there to watch a little baseball while you freeze. You got a blanket on your lap. So,
oh, don't worry. I get the old stories from Charlie. The coldest game ever in the box.
Well, that was Long Beach State. I know, like, that one was... The Long Beach State game was absurd. Yes, that was me. I think it was in the 20s with the wind blowing in at the old box. Yes, he was. He's not wrong.
I miss Hawthorne looking at his watch in the second inning. Oh, from the ice box.
Or you can hear the head. Or when the game goes to extras, you could hear audibly the headphones being slammed on the desk.
One time in Rosenblatt, we're watching another game. And, you know, in the bleachers, they play, you know, the beach ball and stuff like that.
Yeah.
When it comes on. Well, it delays the game for a little bit. I mean, who in the hell goes to the park with a beach ball? Oh, man. Those are the days. Come on, Matthew. Thank you, brother. Good luck this weekend. We got bowl picks tomorrow on the show as well.
All right, Otter. We'll look forward to it. Thank you.
Thank you, buddy.
All right, that is Jimmy Ott. Game Time with Jimmy Ott follows us in Baton Rouge. If you're not in Baton Rouge, online at 1045ESPN.com or the Game Time with Jimmy Ott Facebook page if you want to watch there from Jolie Pearl downtown Baton Rouge, which is an awesome spot, especially when they got the doors open. You're looking there into North Square right there. It's a really, really great spot in downtown Baton Rouge. All right, we appreciate the Aesthetic Medicine and Anti-Aging Clinics of Louisiana, title sponsor of our Thursday shows, Blue Bond in Baton Rouge, Ambassador Caffrey in Lafayette, online, theantiagingclinics.com. Muse, what'd you learn?
Emory Jones to the portal, but after he plays Florida's bowl game.
Oh, that Emory Jones.
That Emory Jones.
I was like, what? Oh, yeah.
How weird is that?
He's going to play in the Gasparilla Bowl. It's why you go to Florida. You'll want to play in that Gasparilla Bowl. Pauly.
Taysom Hill has learned coach speak from Sean Payton.
Got it.
What'd you learn, Matt?
Leah Vann loves bourbon. She's my new best friend. Have a good night.
AFR.
We'll see you. Yes, we'll see you tomorrow. Michelle Weighing and Measurement. Michelle.com. Tell you about Michelle every day, and I love telling you about them because they are a great Louisiana company. A Louisiana company that has been, I was born in Louisiana, has been in Louisiana since 1947. They've continued to grow and expand. Michelle Weighing and Measurement. They're online at Michelle.com. Now, 6 calibration labs in Louisiana, but 29 across 11 different states. Oregon and California and Arizona, down to Louisiana, the East Coast as well. It's Michelle Weighing and Measurement. Remember, maybe whatever industry you're in, you weigh or measure something. They sell, service, rent the products you use to weigh and measure. Weighing systems, products, services, it's all there at the website. But they also have their track system. And this allows you 24/7, 365 access to your calibration certificates, which makes you more efficient. And this is a free service. Learn more. Michelle.com.
There it is, the extra mile on the border of expected and extraordinary for those willing to go further, like Vans customized for work or play, with safety and tech to keep you connected, supported by a 5-star sales service and finance team, and backed by the 1-star you know. So go the extra mile. It's never crowded because so few have what it takes to go there. Mercedes-Benz Vans.
Veggies in the window.
Barbecue guys, born to grill.
Pops, how many steaks you want?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Le posso offrire un caffè?
Andiamo insieme da me, non c'è.
Call Mr. Electric today for electrical repairs, upgrades, and installations.
Bayou Ford has 0% for 60 months on new Ford F-150s. All new Bayou Ford vehicles come with a 1 million mile powertrain warranty. And now 0% for 60 months on Ford F-150s. If you need sales or service, the crew at Bayou Ford is going to do right by you.
Are you a licensed?